Sharks have a decidedly Chicago flavor with former Hawks Doug Wilson, Bob McGill, and Wayne Pressly now wearing the teal and white of the NHL's newest edition. The two teams have met before, though. In mid-October, the Hawks set a team record with two shorthanded goals just 12 seconds apart as the Hawks swamped the Sharks 7-3. Tonight, the Hawks hope to finish the Sharks off as game six of the road trip brings us to the Cow Palace in Daly City. Hello again, everybody. Pat Foley and Dale Tallon in our first visit to the Cow Palace, or as our French-Canadian friends would say, Le Palais du Beef. The Blackhawks taking on the San Jose Sharks. This is their temporary home. They're having a new arena built just about 50 miles down the road in San Jose. And for sort of a makeshift situation, a nice place, and there has yet to be an unsold seat for a Sharks game. They're excited out in the Bay Area.
Well, it's great to be back in this area. Oakland had a franchise for many years. Everybody's excited about coming here, though the fans weren't too excited about going to Oakland. But San Francisco and this whole area, I think, is excited about the Sharks. They've done extremely well on home ice. They've won 10 of their 12 games here. They won last night an exciting finish against Hartford, and this team has got something to prove. They've got some extra people from the Blackhawks. A two-on-one situation here developed late last night, 11 seconds to go. Wayne Pressly across to Fenton, and Fenton put it in, and the Hartford Whalers go 12 games without a loss, so the Blackhawks better be ready because the Sharks have played extremely well here on home ice.
It will be difficult, of course. The Hawks have faced this situation earlier this trip. They had to play the night before. This time it's the Sharks who have a difficult time as far as fatigue is concerned. And of course, the Hawks, after a very busy schedule last week, taking a couple of days to go to a spa. I would imagine some of the old timers, old schoolers of the NHL will be rolling in their graves.
Well, I think it's a good move. After playing five games in seven nights, I think it's not so effective maybe this week, but in the long term, I think as far as team morale, getting some rest, some conditioning in as well, off-ice conditioning, a little golf, a little team spirit, esprit de corps, I think is really going to help this team in the long run. And I expect the Blackhawks, with the Sharks having played, this will be their third game in four afternoons or 4 days. They played Sunday afternoon, don't forget, in Winnipeg. But Blackhawks need to get off to a good start. They need to get some offense. Only one goal in the last two games. Only three power play goals in this road trip. So they need to get that going if they want to be successful for the remaining two games.
When we start talking about this San Jose team, a fellow, of course, very familiar to Chicago fans. I never thought I'd see Doug Wilson wearing anything other than red, black, and white. But he's in Pacific teal now.
Well, he got off to a bit of a slow start because of the injury situation. He hurt his hand and hurt his back, but he's been red hot of late since the prior to the All-Star break. And in the All-Star game, he had a good game. He scored 8 goals in a brief period of time, and he's always a threat, especially in the small building with his booming shot.
The San Jose team has a very promising youngster. They're really raving about Pat Falloon.
Well, they've done the right thing with him. They've kept him back, kept him away from the media. He's a very talented young man. He was a second player taken in the draft. He's got a lot of potential. He's got soft hands. It reminds me a lot of Adam Oates of the St. Louis Blues. You've got to pay attention to him, but you got to be especially attentive to the people around Falloon. He's a great playmaker and passer.
All right, the Blackhawks coming in here after a very busy week, as you know, 5 games in a week, and now at least they've had a couple of days between games.
Well, this is the makings of a tremendous road trip. Two solid performances against San Jose tonight and in St. Louis on Saturday, and they very possibly could have 5 wins, which would be outstanding, and they've got a good chance of taking a run at Detroit for first overall in their division.
Hawks looking for their first goal in a couple of games, failing to score the other night in Los Angeles, and of course, when you look for offense, you look to number 27.
Well, that's true, and I think Roenick will be revitalized and will have a big game tonight. He's having an outstanding season. He's had very few bad games, 38 goals, but he's the key, obviously, offensively for this hockey club.
And Steve Larmer approaches yet another milestone in his consecutive games played streak. After tonight, only one more needed to tie for third overall.
Well, he not only plays at both ends, but he's a solid competitor and takes a lot to keep him out of the lineup. He's played hurt a lot of the time, but it'll take a major situation for him not to play a game.
It's the Chicago Blackhawks against the San Jose Sharks, and we'll come back to Le Palais du Beef after this.
You're an experienced independent investor. You must act decisively and quickly. You need AccuTrade from First National Brokerage Services. AccuTrade is a totally unique direct trading system that lets you buy and sell stocks and pay only 3 cents a share commission. Pick up your phone now and call to find out about AccuTrade.
A touch-tone phone is all you need to tap into AccuTrade 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. This is an investment tool for the serious investor. You only need a minimum of $5,000 equity to open and maintain your account, and there's a minimum commission of just $48. By paying 3 cents a share commission, you're paying less because you know more. Call this number today, and let's go to work.
Call 1-800-972-5300 to find out if Accutrade is for you. If you trade large numbers of shares often, why pay more than 3 cents a share commission? You need Accutrade from First National Brokerage Services.
Yeah, I can tell just by looking at you, you could use some fun, right? Big fun. Las Vegas, Atlantic City, the Caribbean, cruise ships. But you got to take this along, the Players Club card. It's going to save you a lot of money.
Well, that particular weekend, we saved $120 on the room.
Fabulous rooms and first-class resort hotels. Use the card and take 25% off every day, any day. And you like to eat, right? Well, take your Players Club card.
And they just automatically take 25% off of the meal.
And no hassle, saving even more money. Airfare. We're up to half off on shows and entertainment. So why are they so good to you?
There's something about Players Club members that just stands out. They come to places like the Las Vegas Hilton and to the Flamingo Hiltons to have a good time. And that spreads to people around them.
Call Players Club now. You're too smart to pay full price.
New members get 2 free nights in Las Vegas or Atlantic City when the club books their flights. Call now, 1-800-238-3100.
At Belfour, 14-12-5, 2.49 goals against average. Save percentage just under 90%. 4 shutouts. Coming off 2 straight losses, but he did play well in both those games. Jeff Hackett had a brilliant game last night. But he's 6-19-0 to 3.97 goals against average, which is very respectable for the former New York Islander.
The officials for this game, Paul Stewart will be the referee. Jay Scherers and Leon Stickle are the linesmen. All right, ready to go as the Hawks take on the Sharks. And here's the draw, controlled by Chris Chelios in his own end. Clearing it to center, and the Sharks dump it right back in. Smith to play it. Steve Smith. There's it to the neutral zone. Graham, a touch pass for Lemieux. He ran into a check along the far side. Link Gates, then it's carried in a shot and deflected wide by Lemieux off Chelios' centering pass. Now Smith holds it in. Got it in behind the Shark goal. Sutter tries to work his way in front. Gates stops him. Back of the net is Lemieux against Moore. Jason Moore put into the ice. And they wrestle in the far corner. 2 Sharks go down. It's dug out in center. And Lemieux couldn't find it. Smith does with a shot. That's stopped by Hackett and off the end board. Jeff Hackett wants a cover. Now Link Gates trying to go in one of the Hawks. It may be Lemieux, and he's all over him. And Gates had the left hand loose for a couple of short shots. The missing link, Link Gates, one of the tougher hombres in the NHL.
Only 216 minutes in penalties in 35 games. He started teeing off on Lemieux, and I would think the Blackhawks should get a power play out of this situation. Gates was originally drafted by the Minnesota North Stars and picked up in the expansion draft. 216 minutes. This should
that,
be a power
by the play. Way, Dale, in 35 games, he hasn't even played every night.
Drafted, he was a second round pick, as I said, of the North Stars, and I don't understand why there's no power play in this situation. George Kingston behind the bench, his first full campaign as a head coach in the league.
George Kingston, Dale, 52 years old. And as you guessed, the Hawks are going to get a power play out of this. A double roughing minor to Gates and a single to Lemieux. So the Hawks get a power play opportunity. You talked about it before the game. Mike Keenan talked about it. This power play unit has got to start coming through it much more often than it has been.
15% overall in the regular season on the road. Only 24 for 159. Those numbers aren't particularly poor, except the fact that the timing of these power play goals has been poor. They have not taken advantage of the power plays at critical times. And their road record would be much better if they had been able to capitalize with their chances.
And if they get a goal early against this San Jose team, they'll be in great shape. They have scored in their first few power plays against L.A. and it was a scoreless game to the middle part of the second period. An empty net goal made it a 2-0 win for L.A. But
all right, here's the draw. Chelios put it across to Larmer, far point. Steve Larmer setting it up along the boards to Goulet. Into the corner, Sutter moves it back to Goulet, out to the line, and Larmer slipped it back to Goulet, top of the ring, shooting, and he shot it wide. Rebound to the near side. Roenick took a hit, but got it loose to Sutter, whose pass rolled off the end of his stick. The King, the Sharks steal it, and now able to clear it to center ice. Chris Chelios shooting it back into the San Jose zone. Here's a shot, and it's saved by Hackett. A stand-up save as Larmer out-hustled the Shark player to get there, to get a backhand chance. And now Chelios at center. Puts Roenick over the line to Larmer. Top of the circle is shot, and it's a rebound. Shot wide. Oh, Goulet had an open side and shot it wide with a bouncing puck. It's cleared back into the Chicago zone. Chelios there to feed Roenick. Roenick can't find it. Nearly lost it. Now able to hack it away from Mullen. Into the corner it goes. Taken there by Jeremy Roenick with a minute left on the Chicago power play. Now Larmer gets away from a check to center. And Larmer cleared it over the line. Rob Brown with a bouncing puck. Got help from Kuchera. Kuchera lost the handle to Mullen. Clearing.
That's a play by Mullen that time. Instead of rushing up the far boards, he took a look. Saw no one on the near side and put it easily out to the ice.
And there's time for one more rush on this Chicago power play. Steve Smith had his pass stolen. Here's Evason clearing it ahead. The race is on, and a nice play by Kuchera to wrap up Paul Fenton, who scored that game-winning goal last night. Now Rob Brown the other way. Over the line to Gilbert, left side. Gilbert to Brown in the corner. He tried to center it. Now a couple of players go crashing into the San Jose goal, and it comes off to Mooring. We're early in the hockey game, just south of San Francisco in the Cow Palace.
This was me with dull gray hair. I looked washed up. Then I found a whole new way to make my gray look great.
Introducing a new kind of shampoo from the makers of Just for Men Hair Care called Great Looking Gray. Great Looking Gray does more than clean and condition. It gets rid of the dullness, even yellow buildup, brings out the real silver.
What a difference it makes.
New Great Looking Gray shampoo. And for stubborn yellow, new Great Looking Gray anti-yellow treatment.
The Hawks with a power play opportunity that goes by the wayside. They did have some quality chances.
Now Peluso and McGill, before they had the puck drop, are squaring off, and good move. I like what Paul Stewart's doing. Two guys that are no strangers to the rough stuff. Would not line up and have words, and I would imagine this will be an emotional and intense game from Bob McGill. He didn't play last night, so he's well rested. And of course, he was not very happy that he was allowed to come to San Jose or being left unprotected by the Hawks in that expansion situation. So he'll be he'll have both barrels loaded, I would imagine, tonight.
You look at his penalty total, 55 minutes in penalties in 51 games played. That's a very low total for McGill, though he's not taken a lot of foolish penalties throughout his career. Last year, 150 plus minutes with the Blackhawks in 70 games.
Unsportsmanlike penalties to Peluso and McGill.
That is a good call by Stewart when two players like that, before you even drop the puck, try to get involved. The linesman did a good job of getting in. Stewart decided to send him off. That'll settle him down and should be.
And he's a guy, Dale, as you've touched on before, he knows the mind, right?
Well, that's the type of player he was, Stewart, in his brief career. And played in the WHA. He was a tough customer. And he knows what's going on, and he stepped in quickly and broke it up. This is a good play.
Now the draw to Marchman, a long shot. Hackett stopped it, and he gave no rebound with Hudson right there.
Hudson winning the draw cleanly. Marchman playing the far side, the right side, a left-handed shot. It's a big asset offensively, moving in on your forehand, a better angle to shoot from, and he cranked it right on target. Hackett a good reaction to make the save. We'll see some quality chances tonight from the far hash marks. There's a lot of room. And the hash mark to the corner. And most rinks, you won't get many chances. Those are poor angles. But in this building, it seems to be a decent angle to get a chance.
Now the play behind the Shark goal. Hudson tied up by Moore, and Wilson took it away. Both teams are back at full strength now as the Sharks come to center. Here's a long shot from Brian Lawton into the corner after Belfour made the blocker save. And the Hawks try to start back. Greg Gilbert puts it into the Shark zone as Chicago heads for a change. Doug Wilson back for San Jose. Long feed to Jason Moore. Gets the Hawk line trying to center one. Lawton, a bouncing puck, and went right to the goal mouth, and Belfour knocked it out of there. And Goulet then failed to clear it. Now into the corner, Williams put it in there. Lawton took a bump from Goulet. They wrestle in the near corner. Pat Falloon also in there for the Sharks. Oh, Goulet able to come out of there with it with some good board work. And the Hawks chip it out to center ice. Now Steve Smith to Larmer. Larmer over the San Jose line, lost the handle in traffic. Goulet carried to the corner and dropped it back to Chelios, whose pass is broken up. Larmer on the far side poked it free to Smith. Smith back into the corner with it. Now got it to Goulet, who's knocked flying by Rob Zettler. And the ex-North Star Zettler comes out for the Sharks. Rob Zettler's pass stolen nicely by Roenick. To Larmer over the line, back to Roenick, and it just barely missed clicking. Now Roenick back of the net, got it loose to Larmer near circle. Walks back to the deep slot with it. Trying to feed Lemieux, who had it knocked off his stick. Now Smith held it in, got it to Larmer. He centered one, the pass just behind Sutter, however. Now Sutter put it in front, it comes through to the near side. And the Sharks, Odgers, Jeff Odgers bounces it out to center ice. 5 minutes gone in a scoreless first in San Jose, and a long feed just failing to click as the Sharks tried to spring Fenton, and it's an icing call as a result. Still early in the game at the Cow Palace, the Hawks and the Sharks are scoreless.
Get ready to launch yourself into the world of Air and Space Smithsonian, a world that captivates the imagination. Satellites, superjets, soaring, something different every other month. There's no other magazine like Air and Space, and with your subscription comes membership in the National Air and Space Museum in Washington.
To order Air and Space, call 800-841-0300 and receive a full year, six issues for just $18 with membership in the National Air and Space Museum. 800-841-0300.
Well, the Sharks have done an amazing job of marketing their logo and their colorful uniforms. Amazing. They've even been surprised by the desire of fans, not only hockey fans, but sports fans all around the country.
Icing call against the Sharks. That's right. Their stuff is being sold, I think, at a faster clip than any other team, certainly in the NHL, and maybe one of the top teams in all of sport. They really have done a great job marketing-wise. We mentioned this building holds 10,888. This is their 27th home game. There has not been an unsold seat yet. And, of course, people don't come here with great expectations in terms of winning, but whenever the team does put together a good performance, they're well rewarded. They've been a very enthusiastic crowd by and large here in the Cow Palace. And that even though these people know that 2 years from now this team will be playing 50 miles down the road in San Jose, and by all accounts that new building that's being put up is going to be quite a palace.
Well, they've refurbished this building. They've done a nice job here in the press area, and now they got some fine dining here in the Cow Palace. I think that title would be an oxymoron, I would think.
That's something that is particularly attractive. However, we are happy to report that the ambience of the rink would not. Now we got a fight off the draw as Peluso drops the gloves with McGill, and they're going at it in front of the San Jose goal. And each man has landed a couple of big shots, and now the linesmen are able to get in there.
Well, we've seen McGill over the years, pound for pound, there isn't anybody tougher. He'll go at anybody, anytime, any size, and never back down.
still a scoreless hockey game.
Only $29.95. Become an Insiders member now.
Who joins these NFL fan clubs anyway?
I did, and I got a lifetime membership in my team's fan club, plus discounts on special merchandise for only $29.95.
$29.95?
Yeah, plus this exclusive membership kit with offers worth over $150.
How do I join?
Send $29.95, your name, address, and favorite team to Insiders, P.O. Box 9101, Oak Brook, Illinois, 60522, or call 900-535-9000 for details. Become an Insider of your favorite team now.
Well, McGill and Peluso had trouble lining up on their last shift. Their next shift, they go at it right in front of the net. Peluso trying to forecheck. He goes at McGill. McGill tries to slow up. They drop their gloves, and I think Peluso should get two for instigating. And the Blackhawks will be shorthanded for the first time in the game. The Sharks go to the power play. A power play. Overall, 40 for 259, 23 of those goals on home ice. And obviously the key, Doug Wilson on the point.
He scored a power play goal last night. Here's Larmer, a long shot, good save by Hackett. Rebound to the Sharks, Tony Herkus. Now Moore, Jason Moore. Cleared into center, David Bruce, dumping it in. Around the boards to the near side, Herkus came up with it to the line, and Moore takes a look, then put it back to Herkus. It was up over his stick into the corner. Tony Herkus able to get it back along the boards. Wilson sneaks in, Herkus couldn't find him, then Moore shoots one, and he shot it up off the glass. Now Mullen, out to the corner, then the return pass has Mullen on the near side. Out to the line, Bruce, or Moore, over the Wilson with a long shot that's blocked. Graham picks it up and clears.
I think Steve Larmer just happened to be in the neighborhood. That just hit him. I don't think anybody in their right mind would attempt to try and block that shot.
Pat Falloon over the Hawk line. His drop pass broken up, then re-stolen by the Sharks. Centering pass, and Williams tried to feed Falloon and just missed him. And Sutter couldn't get it by Gates. Put it around the boards. And they scramble in the near corner. Falloon came up with it. Pat Falloon on the near boards, got it to Gates, now Lutt. Back into the corner. Everybody battles along the near side, and Paul Stewart sounds the whistle with half a minute to go on the San Jose power play.
Well, Brent Sutter had possession and sort of took a funny hop. He mishandled it, was kept in, and Floon attempted to deflect the shot, I think on purpose. He let it get by him to try and startle Belfort, and fortunately for the Blackhawks, missed the net. Falloon is leading the team in scoring with 14 goals and 15 assists.
The they start playing the Jaws music here, and everybody gives it the old shark salute. The Jaws. Quite a scene to look around the building, and a high percentage of people were making that Jaws type move a moment ago. Here's a long shot deflecting into the crowd.
It looked like you in the press room having a free meal. What's the matter? Out of meal money after this extended trip? I know you're out of underwear and socks.
Faceoff will be just outside the Chicago line. A pretty nice dry cleaning bill down there at La Costa.
You're almost better off buying new stuff. That's what I did anyway.
Well, the draw taken by the Sharks. Then Lawton's pass hits the skate and all the way back into the San Jose zone. Graham tying up his man in the corner. Then the Sharks come out with it. And the missing link. Link Gates puts it over the hog line. His pass deflecting to Larmer. He whacked it ahead to Graham, trying to get it to Lauer, and he was tied up. Otherwise, Lauer might have had a break. He was the man serving the extra Hawk penalty. Both teams are at full strength. Here's a giveaway. Roenick centered. Larmer! Bouncing puck. He couldn't get it to sit down. Now Chelios holds it in. Around the board to Roenick behind the net. Roenick tries to center. Larmer, the shot. His stick tied up. Rebound to Chelios, and he shot it wide. It caroms all the way back to center. Now the race is on. Here's a steal by Lawton, cutting in, shooting, Belfort. Shut the door on the short side. 12 minutes to go in a scoreless first period in San Jose.
Get ready for TVKO's February Fight of the Month. Merciless Ray Mercer versus Larry Holmes. Mercer's an undefeated heavyweight with 13 KOs. After his vicious knockout of Tommy Morrison, he's in line for the title. But now he faces a legend. Holmes is out to prove he's back as he faces his toughest challenge. One's coming on strong, one's coming back. The Last Stand, Power versus Pride, live on pay-per-view cable TV. Call your cable operator now to order this pay-per-view event.
Having difficulty finding the mark. The puck by Chelios shot around, shot wide on a good scoring chance. But Smith bumps into the linesman. Lawton strips the puck. Two-on-one situation. Belfour's best save is only his real first tough save of the night on Brian Lawton, the former first-round pick of the Minnesota North Stars.
Now in the Hawks zone, Manisek Kuchera. Working his way ahead and the long feed to Rob Brown over the line. His back pass didn't get to Ronick. And now the Sharks take over. Bozek gave it to Moore. Mason Moore bouncing it out to center ice. Presley lost the handle and Ronick dumps it back behind the San Jose goal. Now over to the far side. Benton pushed it ahead. Bozek beating Presley. Couldn't kick it to the stick. And Rob Brown puts it back into the Shark end. Now on the near side, here's Tonelli in the corner taking a look, trying to center one. Marchman sneaking in, he couldn't pull the trigger, however. And into the far corner goes Hudson against Zettler. Mike Hudson kicked it loose. Tonelli trying to jam it out of there on Bozek. Now Brown works his way to the slot, gets knocked down before he could shoot it. San Jose out 3-on-2 if they hurry. More and mishandled it as he came to the Hawk line. And Jose off for a change anyway. Then a long feed. Bounces around at the Shark line.
Nice kick by Mike Hudson.
Shin-high pass that Hudson gave it the old Pele. Now the Hawks hold it in a chance. And a save by Hackett. Rebound to the doorstep. And Hackett covered it up after making a dandy point-blank save on Ron Buskin.
Well, Hackett has made some good saves. The Blackhawks have had some chances. If Hackett hasn't made the save, they've shot the puck wide. Good pinch at the blue line by Buskus to Goulet. Goulet against the flow, returns to Buskus, who made the play at the blue line, and off the left bicep of Hackett. And another faceoff just to his left.
Nearing the halfway point of the opening period. Neither team has scored yet. Good percentage of the play has been in the San Jose zone. A few great scoring chances for the Hawks so far. Here's a long shot. Hackett, the save, rebound cleared back to center ice. Hawks dump it back in. Sutter into the near corner. Put it around the boards and it's a flex to Wilson. He feeds Odgers, clearing to center. And Dean Evason circling for San Jose. That is pass deflected. Gets knocked down. Marchman's going to get a penalty. He stuck the leg out in a dangerous maneuver. And the Sharks dump it in. The Hawks control. The whistle sounds. And Jeff Odgers may have something to say to Marchman. Now he'll peel back as he knows his team's going to get a power play.
For Tripp.
Halfway through the opening period at the Cow Palace, no score.
When sports scream, when arms are sore, when legs ache, when muscles hurt. Why Sports Cream? Massaging Sports Cream In brings fast pain relief. No medicine-y smell, no odor. Why Sports Cream? Because it works.
Athlete's foot. Every year, over 28 million Americans get it. Try NP27. Its doctor-recommended ingredient stops burning and itching fast. NP27. Nothing's a better cure for athlete's foot.
Ryan Marchman stuck his leg out, tripped Odgers. Odgers went to go after him, thought better of it, showed good restraint. The Sharks are going to go to the power play. Very narrow neutral zone. Not a lot of room between the blue lines in this smaller building. Believe it or not, it's smaller than the stadium. It's 185 feet long.
Here's a steal by Ronick. He has a break, cutting in shorthanded, and then the puck jumped over his stick just as he was ready to make his final move. The puck rolled away from him. He never did get a shot off, and the Sharks dump it into the Hawk zone. Armour jammed it off the boards, and Chelios cleared it.
Moore had it stripped away by Roenick at the blue line of the Blackhawks. Link Gates and Jason Moore on the points on the power play here.
Now Moore here to the Hawk line. Nice steal by Steve Smith, and he shot it back the other way. Ryan Lott cleared it to the left wing boards. Knocked away from Bruce up over the boards into the bench area. And Chicago fans who have been hockey fans before 1980, let's see if we can hear the PA announcer here and see if you can identify this voice.
Sweatshirts, caps, jackets, and much, much more. For all of your Shark shopping needs, stop by the Shark store in Valco Fashion Park, Cupertino.
I don't know, but he's got something growing out of his right ear.
Maybe we can get, I thought we had a direct feed to the PA. Maybe we'll, that was on the air. I didn't hear it in my ear, but that's a little Chicago Blackhawk trivia. Who did that voice belong to? The answer in a moment. Here come the Sharks.
Man in the penalty box.
Good answer. Al Wilson into the far corner, put it in behind the goal. Here's a centering pass. Mullen had a jump over his stick, held in by Williams. David Williams, a long shot, missing the net. Doug Wilson at the far point. Clears it around the boards. Mullen after it behind the net. Not able to pick it up. Now Bruce does. Put it in there deep. Now a centering pass, chopped at by Bruce. He's knocked down. Belfort stopped him. Now at the line is Wilson. Clears it up the boards. Now Williams near point. Into the near circle. Mullen shoots one. And Belfort got a piece of that. Rebound to the corner. And the Hawks look to clear and unable to get it out of there. Bodies flying all over, but a hand pass is ruled against San Jose to stop the play.
Mullen not afraid to shoot. We talked about the angles here that guys are going to take shots from the bottom of the circle, from the hash marks. They've got better angles here because of the deep corners. The pass out front, hacked at. Belfort getting the blocker on it and deflecting it into the corner. You see the position here that Mullen is in. He's trying to shoot from to score. He's at the bottom of the circle, and he still has a pretty good angle at Belfort, and Belfort got a piece of it. 4 seconds remaining on the second San Jose power play.
Just under 8 minutes left in a scoreless first period in San Jose. Here's the draw, ducked into the Hog zone. Both teams are back at full strength. And it's in the far corner. Wesley's pass doesn't get through, and Tinelli gets yanked down. Marchman carries on. Ryan Marchman puts it into Shark territory. Rob Zettler on it. Zettler up the boards to Presley. Here's to center and Tinelli. And his pass deflect. Oh, taken by Bob McGill. Then he overskated it, and now he gets it back. McGill gave it to Presley, who chips it into the Chicago end of the ice. Jocelyn Lemieux back for it. Lemieux to Chelios. Clearing it back to the neutral zone. And Moore had his pass deflect. Locked back into the Shark zone, but Brown's feet broken up by Jason Moore. Then he ran right into Gilbert, who holds it in. Moore returns the favor on Gilbert. Now Presley with the puck, able to put it off the glass. Back into Chicago ice. Center, and now they're in there offside. 6.5 to go in the first period. The Hawks nothing and the Sharks nothing.
Oh no, my hair's not only going gray, now it's getting thinner. I wish they made something for gray thinning hair.
They have Grecian Plus. Grecian Plus is a fresh-smelling foam that gradually brings back natural-looking color, the famous Grecian way. But this Grecian has a big plus. It builds body for healthier, fuller-looking hair.
Your hair looks great. Feels thicker, too.
Grecian Plus, the total treatment for gray, thinning hair.
Pat Foley and Dale Talon end back in the Cow Palace as the puck is shot down into San Jose territory. Now the Sharks out to center. Perry Anderson over the Hawk line. Chupon shot it wide. Addison to the near board. Put it into the corner. Perry Anderson tied up there by Dirk Graham. Anderson trying to work it loose. Then his pass winds up back at center. Bob McGill flipping it in there. Taken by Rod Buskus. Now Marchman. Moves it back the other way. Doug Wilson will have to play it. Give it to McGill on the near side. Up the board to Falloon. Nice feed to center, and the play broken up by Kucher at the Hawk defense as Sullivan couldn't control it. Williams back in his own end for San Jose to Falloon, and Williams got a rough ride from Peluso after he made the pass. Larmer holds it in, but then it's cleared away out to the neutral zone. Zettler. Let his pass deflect. And Williams carried it ahead. He ran into Peluso again. And they wrestle along the near side. Larmer came out of there with it. Centered one. Kuchera looks for Hudson. Just rolled over his stick. Hudson pulled down. And there'll be a penalty coming up against San Jose. Blackhawks head to the power play, getting to the late part of the first. We're still scoreless.
Get ready to launch yourself into the world of Air and Space Smithsonian, a world that captivates the imagination. Satellites, superjets, soaring, something different every other month. There's no other magazine like Air and Space, and with your subscription comes membership in the National Air and Space Museum in Washington.
To order Air and Space, call 800-841-0300 and receive a full year, six issues for just $18 with membership in the National Air and Space Museum. 800-841-0300.
Mark Sullivan gets the first, or gets a penalty. Meanwhile, a good hit by Peluso on Sullivan, and then Sullivan pulls down Mike Hudson on a feed from Larmer, or Kucher, I should say. Yanked down from behind. Sullivan goes to the box. Penalty for hooking at 15:23 in the second power play of the night for the Blackhawks. Sullivan, Boston University product, played last year with San Diego in the International Hockey League. San Diego drawing extremely well. About 10,000 people a game for their league games.
Now the Hawk power play. Smith at the far point, up the board to Tonelli. John Tonelli, side of the net to Brown. Rob Brown takes a look, looks for Tonelli. The puck rolled free, then Hudson took a whack at it, and Hackett made a good save. Now it's held in by Chelios. Put it around the board, deflecting over to the far corner, and Brown. Rob Brown, deep slot to Smith, gave it back to Brown. And then he had it knocked away by Bruce out to center ice. Chelios back to Tonelli over the line, moving in, shooting, and that hit. A defenseman Gates, and the Sharks clear it down all the way. Chris Chelios sends Smith to center. Chipped it to the left corner, taken by Sutter. Winds it around the board. Smith holds it in for Larmer. Wilson took it away, and Evason cleared it. And there's a minute left on the Chicago power play. 3.5 to go in the first. Still no score in San Jose as the Hawks power play tries to get on track. Here's Larmer in the offensive zone to Roenick in the corner. Back to Larmer behind the net, wrestling with McGill, who takes it away and clears.
McGill and Larmer going at it hot and heavy in the corner, and then as McGill was going off for a player change, Larmer ran him over.
Larmer cranks it in there. Tony Herkes couldn't get it by Marchman, who shoots one that didn't get through, and the Sharks try to counter. Here's Bozek over the line, centered one, and a penalty to be called. Larmer yanked down Tony Herkes, who otherwise would have been in alone. Larmer took the feet from under him, and he knows he'll be getting a penalty.
And Marchman's shot blocked.
Hercus with the pass across to Bozek. Bozek back to Hercus. Hercus was in. Larmer at the end of a shift, a long shift. He'd been out there over a minute on the power play, and he had to take him down. A necessary penalty nullifying the remaining 7 seconds on the penalty to Sullivan.
Again, who is this voice?
16.
I hope you heard the tail end of that. The answer to our little trivia. The PA announcer here in San Jose, Bud Kelly, who did the play-by-play and color at different times for the Blackhawks in the late 70s. Bud now the PA announcer here for all the Shark home games. Now here's the draw in the Hog zone with four skaters aside. Belfour able to knock it away from Mullen to the near corner. Now the Shark penalty over there on the power play. It's in behind the Hawk net. Now to the near point. It's Link Gates putting it up the board for Mullen. Ryan Mullen sends it across to the far point. Williams put it around the board. Kallios picked it off to Sutter, and he chopped it to the Shark line. Power play hockey for San Jose. Link Gates for Brian Mullen to center. Bangs it in there. Belfour leaves it for Kuchera. He got tied up behind the net. Puck bouncing free and corralled by Roenick. He tries to feather it ahead. It's picked off, then Roenick carries on. Turning in the slot, shooting, and a save by Hackett. What an effort by Roenick to get rid of that shot. And Hackett had to make a good save on the Hawks sniper.
Hawks getting better chances while shorthanded than with the power play.
A minute now remaining in the Shark power play. Here's Wilson over the line. Wilson dropped it to the near side. Then a penalty coming up. It was knocked down with a stick above the shoulder.
The Sharks got away with one. They had six players on the ice. Should have been too many men on the ice. They had a guy on the ice well outside the 5-foot buffer zone for at least 2 or 3 seconds, but no one caught it. The Blackhawk bench, the coaches standing up, but they had too many men on the ice and no one saw it. Meanwhile, Jeremy Roenick with a spectacular shorthanded chance. Bouncing puck bouncing all over, getting worse as the period wears on. Bouncing pass, intercepted. The defenseman fell down. Roenick went to the backhand, quickly stopped, spun around, went to the forehand, and Jeff Hackett just got a piece of it with the left skate. And right after that, the Sharks with a poor change at six men on the ice. And no one noticed it except the Blackhawks side.
Now the draw in the Chicago zone. Comes around to the near side. Graham. And a jam it loose. Couldn't get out. Wilson fired. Belfour. Good save as Wilson walked right to the top of the ring unchallenged. And Wilson got all of that rocket. And Belfour able to go down to make the stop. And now the Hawks waste a little time before clearing. Final minute of the opening period as Doug Wilson had his pass deflect. And he gets to it in the Hawk zone. Centering Bruce shoots one. Belfour the save. And he's able to smother it with a couple of Sharks lurking around the Hawk net.
Doug Wilson keeping in the clearing attempt by Chelios. Right at the line, drifted to the far side. Got it in front of the net. Bruce just turned around and let it go. A screenshot. Smith tried to block it. Wilson keeps it in. Takes a look. Bruce in the deep slot. Bruce let it go. Smith tried to block it. Belfour didn't pick it up till it was by Smith. And Belfour makes a good save. Prior to that, though, three Blackhawk players on the one side, leaving Doug Wilson a clear lane along the left point, moved into the top of the circle, tried to go low to the stick side. Belfour got the pad on it. So a couple of good saves by Ed Belfour here on the last moments of their third power play.
Off to the right of Ed Belfour. Going for his 15th win of the year. 14-12-5 coming into the action. The Blackhawks as a team, four games over 500. Bozek and Roenick in the Hawk zone, and Bozek got the draw to Presley. Presley trying to pick his way in front. Center one. This is the same combination that won the game last night with 11 seconds left. And they score the first goal tonight as Presley sets up Fenton It's 1-0 Sharks.
The Sharks, with the waning seconds of the power play, win the draw. Bozek kicks it to Presley. Presley picks it up on the far side, stops, makes a nice move to get around Steve Smith. Backhand pass right across the goal mouth to Fenton. Fenton buried it. Great stick handling maneuver by Wayne Presley after Bozek won the draw. Presley undressed Smith and slipped the backhander past Chelios, who went down on one leg, and Fenton buried the perfect pass. Super individual effort by Presley.
Sharks have the first goal. Here's Roenick over the line, trying to center one, and Tinelli will go whack at it, but didn't connect. Chelios centered. Roenick, a shot deflected over top of the net. Now McGill for San Jose, able to lift it back to the Chicago line, and it was knocked down there with a stick above the shoulder. And Steve Smith's going to get a penalty. Smith was upset with that call being made for a stick above the shoulder, and he turned as he touched the puck. He just fired it in the direction of Jay Scher as the linesman, and Paul Stewart's going to give him a penalty.
Smith can't believe it. Neither can the Blackhawks. Dumped into the neutral zone by Bob McGill. Swatted down. Puck's bouncing, and Smith just turns and rips it off the glass, and that's a legitimate penalty call. Unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for shooting the puck well after the whistle, and just because it was close to the official share, that's why the penalty. And 18.9 seconds. The Sharks with a 1-0 lead on a late goal. Penalty time had expired. Is it a power play goal?
Here's a long shot saved by Belfour. Rebound bouncing in the slot, and Belfour able to gather it in before the Sharks can get to it. I believe that Paul Fenton's goal is technically an even strength goal.
The draw won again by the Sharks. Quick wrist shot by Wilson. Knocked down in front. Good save. And the bouncing puck, no one can locate it except Belfour. So the Sharks doing some good work on the faceoffs here, getting some chances on their power play. Get the lone goal on a power at the end of a power play because of a faceoff win. And they very nearly made it 2-0 with another faceoff just inside the line.
Chelios clears the ensuing faceoff down the length, and that's going to do it for the opening period. Well, the Sharks get a late first period goal to grab a 1-0 lead.
The Sharks coming out aggressive in their own building. At the end of one period of play, they take a 1-0 lead over the Blackhawks. The goal came very late in the period, and a former Blackhawk was the one who set it up for the San Jose Sharks. The Sharks force a faceoff to the right of Ed Belfour late in the period. Steve Bozek wins it. Then it's Wayne Presley taking it down below the red line. Goes over to Paul Fenton for his 7th goal of the year. San Jose takes a 1-0 lead. Presley getting the assist. The goal coming at 19:16. As for the shots on goal during the opening period, 10-10. But the Sharks have a 1-0 lead at the end of one period of play. When we come back, we'll have scores from around the NHL. That's when we continue during the first intermission here on Sports Channel.
You're an experienced independent investor. You must act decisively and quickly. You need AccuTrade from First National Brokerage Services. AccuTrade is a totally unique direct trading system that lets you buy and sell stocks and pay only 3 cents a share commission. Pick up your phone now and call to find out about AccuTrade.
A touchtone phone is all you need to tap into AccuTrade 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. This is an investment tool for the serious investor. You only need a minimum of $5,000 equity to open and maintain your account, and there's a minimum commission of just $48. By paying 3 cents a share commission, you're paying less because you know more. Call this number today, and let's go to work.
Call 1-800-972-5300 to find out if AccuTrade is for you. If you trade large numbers of shares often, why pay more than 3 cents a share commission? You need AccuTrade from First National Brokerage Services.
No matter what your age, credit, or income, when you need money, turn to Metropolitan Mortgage.
The roof was leaking, plaster was falling from the ceiling.
And you couldn't get a bank loan?
I'm a single parent, couldn't prove my income. I'm a woman. It all adds up to, sorry, try someone else.
Well, you obviously got a loan from someone.
Metropolitan Mortgage. And that I need a little extra money to pay my bills wasn't even a consideration. I had equity in my home, and that's all that mattered.
When you need money to pay bills and have just one small monthly payment, turn to us.
My mother's medical bills, property back taxes, high interest credit cards.
A lot of pressure.
Pressure? I was at my wit's end. If it hadn't been for Metropolitan Mortgage, I don't know what I would have done.
A lot of bills.
But I also had a lot of equity in this house. I applied for an equity loan at every bank in this county. They turned me down. Metropolitan Mortgage didn't.
Stop by the office nearest you or from anywhere in Florida. Call 1-800-EASY-YES. 1-800-EASY-YES.
At the end of one period of play, the Blackhawks trail the San Jose Sharks by a score of 1-0. And the Blackhawks need to win tonight in order to keep pace with the Detroit Red Wings in the Norris Division. The Red Wings have already won. They were a winner at home tonight over Washington by a final score of 4-1. Kelly Johansson's goal in the final minute of play broke up Tim Chevalier's shutout. Elsewhere, Toronto gets a goal from Wendell Clark in overtime to beat the Minnesota North Stars. The Rangers on a goal by Adam Graves midway through the third period, a shorthanded goal, beat the Pittsburgh Penguins by a final of 4-3. Quebec and Calgary are tied up 2-2. They are just about ready to go into the second intermission in that one. And Montreal is at Edmonton tonight. Edmonton is playing at home. Montreal playing after a tough loss to Vancouver last night. And as you might expect, Edmonton has the lead 1-0. This is a battle of backup goalies, Rasico and Foster, in the nets tonight. In other sports news, the Bulls are playing the Phoenix Suns. Michael Jordan is not there. He's been fined and suspended for a game because of what happened in Salt Lake City the other night. You'll be able to see the Bulls and the Suns coming up following the Hawks game right here on Sports Channel. Big night in college basketball. There are no more undefeated teams in the college ranks. Number one ranked Duke in the final seconds had a chance to tie North Carolina or win it with a three. The Devils go to the meal, ticket Christian Laettner. He couldn't get it to fall. North Carolina beats Duke 75-73. And second-ranked Oklahoma State, they were also undefeated until tonight. They were a loser to Nebraska 85-69. Coming up next, Dale Talon is going to talk with Doug Wilson. And as we head out to the break, here is a look at the Blackhawks Alka-Seltzer Plus, plus-minus leaders.
Hi, I'm Fred Drasner, president of U.S. News & World Report, and if you call this toll-free number right now, we're not going to send you some cheap designer phone. Instead, we're going to send you something much more valuable. News you can really use. It's about your family, your home, your business. Absolutely free.
This exclusive new video, Building Financial Success, can be yours free if you call right now for U.S. News. It will teach you about money matters that matter to you and provide you with easy proven strategies you can use today. In a moment, you'll find out more.
Bart Simpson on the cover of Time? And why America loves the Simpsons? Are you really interested in those questions? At U.S. News and World Report, we're not. We're concerned about you. That's why we bring you News You Can Use. With issues on how to build your fortune, the best colleges for your kids, and how to get the best jobs for the future. All this, plus how the news of the world affects you.
Call now for U.S. News and get your free video, Building Financial Success, hosted by financial planning expert Steve Crowley. This 40-minute video will guide you in making important decisions about career choices, retirement, investing, saving for college, home mortgages, and much more. You'll also get the companion book, Your Financial Planner, with easy ways to reach your personal goals. This valuable video and book are not available in stores. Both are yours free with your paid subscription to U.S. News. Call now for U.S. News at our greatest savings ever. This is our guaranteed lowest price. You'll get 30 weekly issues for four low payments of just $3.75, or use your credit card. Our lowest price, guaranteed. Lower than Time, lower than Newsweek, guaranteed. Plus our personal guarantee.
Take it home, drive it around the block, kick the tires, and if you don't like it, send it back to us and we'll give you your money back.
30 issues, incredible low price, and the book and video are yours free. Call now, 1-800-228-8400.
Three former Blackhawks playing for the Sharks tonight. Wayne Pressly had an assist. Bob McGill got in a fight with Mike Peluso. And Dale Talon is standing by with the third member of the former Blackhawks trio that plays for the San Jose Sharks.
Thank you very much, Jim. After one period of play, it's the Sharks 1 and the Blackhawks nothing. And one of my all-time idols, Doug Wilson, the captain of the San Jose Sharks. Dougie, it's got to feel a little bit more comfortable for you the second time around. That game in Chicago Stadium had to be nerve-wracking for you. Are you more relaxed tonight?
Well, we are. I mean, that it was good to get that first game over with. I've got so many great memories of the Chicago Stadium, and but this is more of a hockey game for us.
Doug, the team really exciting in this building. The team has played extremely well, winning 10 games. You're getting a lot of support here in the area. Great fan support.
Well, the fans have been outstanding. It's much like the Chicago Stadium. I think what's happened is we're a hard-working team. We can't match up offensively, but our work ethic matches with anybody.
Doug, you played on so many contending teams, so many good Blackhawk teams. Now with an expansion team, is it frustrating for you as far as maybe winning a Stanley Cup? This team has got a long way to go, obviously, but how do you keep that away from being a negative?
Well, what it is we've set our own goals. Obviously, we want to get in the playoffs as quick as possible. We've already attained one goal, and that was to beat every team in our division. We've played well, and we've got some young guys that have really come to the forefront, and this hockey team is going to be very successful in the very near future.
Doug, any different feeling for you against seeing some of your teammates out there? Is it still a tough pill for you to swallow?
Well, I mean, I look across. I see a lot of true friends that I have over there, and I wish them the best. I mean, I've been very fortunate to play in a great city like Chicago for 14 years, and the fans treated me and my family so well, and I thank them for that. And now we've turned the page on a new chapter, and this is just as fun and exciting, and just different goals for us.
Well, your handicap's probably a lot lower. I'll have to give you a lot less as far as shots are concerned from now on, so book that one, and everybody will be witness to that. But congratulations on a great Chicago career and on to bigger and better things here with San Jose. Thanks for stopping by.
Thanks, Dale. I'd love to thank all the Chicago people for all the great support they've given me.
Well, I'm sure they like to thank you very much for all the great moments you've given them. Doug Wilson, our guest. Now back to you, Jim Blaney.
Thanks so much, Dale. And it still looks a little strange not seeing Doug Wilson in a Blackhawks uniform, but he's helping out build a franchise in San Jose. When we come back, we are going to go back to Daly City. Pat Foley and analysis. The Hawks trail at the end of one period of play, 1-0 to the Sharks.
Larry Bird was born to be a champion. He was instilled with a competitive fire and passion that would never die.
One way or another, Bird kills you.
Now there's a steal by Bird. Underneath the D.J. Lane.
Larry Joe Bird was destined for glory in the game he loved. Get bird watching at its best in this amazing video. Larry Bird, a basketball legend. It's free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, the best way to capture all the drama of sports every week.
There's only one place I'd rather be, French Lick.
Through rare footage, you'll follow the victory trail from the cornfields and basketball courts of Indiana to the hallowed halls of the Boston Garden, where the talented young Hoosier resurrects a fallen dynasty. Call this toll-free number now and be there when the championships are won. Share the glory, live the moments with the man who touched all who saw him play.
Larry Bird never quits.
He has eyes all around his head.
We can always give it to Larry. He needs to step back and shoot a three.
Bird, 4-3. Yes!
Exclusive footage captures the hard-fought and emotional duels with longtime rival Magic Johnson.
This game is Larry Bird. I mean, he's doing everything.
This official NBA video is a thrilling 60 minutes that you'll enjoy again and again, free from Sports Illustrated. Get your free video in a full year of Sports Illustrated. 54 issues, including the swimsuit issue, for only $1.29 an issue. Save over 55% off the cover price, and you may use your credit card. Follow all your favorites and all the excitement in Sports Illustrated. Call now to subscribe or renew and get this memorable video free. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. Don't miss this heartwarming tale of a boy who lived his dreams, the dreams of a champion. It's the story of a legend. The legend lives in Sports Illustrated. Call now.
The Blackhawks just got off the golf course in La Costa before they headed for this game for San Jose. The San Jose Sharks have yet to beat a Norris Division opponent, so for the Blackhawks, this game is like a par five that's reachable in two. If the Blackhawks don't birdie this game, they're going to be losing ground to the field. For the first period analysis, let's go back to Daly City to Pat Foley and Dale Town.
Well, thank you, Jim Longhurst, back in the Sports Channel studios. You're right, though. The Blackhawks do feel like they have to win this game. Anybody that plays this team feels like they let 2 points get away if they don't beat them, and therein lies the pressure. Well, therein lies the pressure with the Blackhawks, with only one goal in their last seven periods. They seem to be stressed out a bit offensively. They're trying to make perfect shots, and they're missing the net. They're squandering a lot of quality chances. They outplayed the Sharks for 18 and a half minutes at even strength. Had some quality chances, but just trying to be too perfect. And then Jeff Hackett made some good saves. Then late in the game, as the power play ended, the faceoffs, the Sharks winning some important faceoffs, and that created a great chance here. Wayne Pressly stops, gets the puck in midair, gets away from Smith. He hacks at it. Smith tries to get at him, and Pressly makes a perfect backhand pass to Fenton, who was all alone, and that was the lone goal of the period. Excellent play from Wayne Pressly to set up Fenton.
The Hawks did have probably an edge in the scoring chances, and one of the good ones they had was from a defenseman.
Well, Buskus pinched in, got it to Goulet. Buskus kept going to net. I like to see a defenseman do that. Goulet saw him coming, put it on the money, and Hackett with a good save, just getting a piece of it with the left bicep. That was the type of period it was, a frustrating period. The Hawks down by a goal, but yet they outplayed the Sharks, their offense letting them down. They got to get some breaks somehow and just start shooting the puck. Instead of trying to be perfect with the shots, they just got to get it on net and hope for the best.
Chances have been there, the goals have not been, and we're through 20 minutes of play in the Cow Palace here in San Jose, or just north of San Jose. It's the Sharks 1, the Hawks nothing. The second period follows this timeout.
The best performing portfolios of the 90s will have a key new ingredient you need to know. The state of Virginia's retirement fund just added $100 million of this new element, and they're planning for up to $500 million more. It's not stocks, bonds, or real estate. It's managed futures accounts, the newest asset class. Whether you have a financial advisor or you make your own investment decisions, you need this book on adding managed futures to your portfolio. A $10 value free from the Investment Club. Dial 1-800-4-MA-BOOK now. It's filled with charts, tables, mathematical formulas, and much, much more. During the last 10 years, managed futures investment volume has grown from $500 million to $20 billion and could top $50 billion by the end of the 90s. Most financial advisors agree that sooner or later, managed futures accounts will be in every portfolio. Get your free book now on adding managed futures to your portfolio. Call 1-800-4-MA-BOOK.
Hi, I'm Lorenzo Quinn. I've been telling you about incredible opportunities now opening up to collectors of authentic limited edition prints signed by Salvador Dali. Since his passing in 1989, the value of many of his works have proven to be an intelligent acquisition. That is why, in collaboration with the Salvador Dali Archives, this full color catalog was created that contains over 350 of Dali's greatest limited edition prints. It is an indispensable guide to anyone interested in documented, authentic print works of Salvador Dali. So whether you are an established collector or just thinking of getting started, I urge you to call now for information on how to acquire this important catalog. Every caller will receive a free copy of the Salvador Dali Collector's Newsletter with all the latest information about exhibits, auctions, price trends, and much, much more. It's a $10 value, absolutely free, no obligation. So please call 1-800-4-DALI. Thank you.
Sports fans, here's your chance to be a hero for kids. Join Horace Grant, Ed Belfour, Frank Thomas, Jim Harbaugh, and Sean Dunston for the 5th Annual Sports Channel Sports Awards, Monday, February 10th at the Stouffer's Riviera Hotel. The event will be telecast on Sports Channel and benefits the March of Dimes Birth Defects Foundation. For tickets, call 312-407-4007. Our next Blackhawk game on Sports Channel Saturday at 7:30. The Blackhawks will take on the Blues live from the arena in St. Louis at 7:30 on Sports Channel and 7:20 on WBBM News Radio 78. Well, a switch here for the Blackhawks. The Blackhawks normally have to go up the stairs to get on stadium ice, but here in the Cow Palace, the locker rooms are upstairs. They have to go downstairs and then across and onto the ice. Here in the refurbished Cow Palace.
And the Shark mascot that does a good job in the stands. Boy, what a way they had to introduce the Shark mascot, the first time that they ever used this mascot at a home game. They brought the Zamboni out onto the ice amidst a bunch of smoke. You know how you get the dry ice makes the smoke if you get it wet, and they lifted up the Zamboni, and from all this smoke, the Shark came racing out onto the ice. much to the delight of the fans. Here we go in the second period, a minute and a half remaining on a Chicago penalty. And San Jose with a 1-0 lead is on the power play. It's deep in the San Jose zone, but now Tony Herkes clears it to center. Graham broke it up there to Chelios, who cleared. Now the Sharks work their way back into the hog zone. Herkes on the far side, dropped it into the slot, bouncing puck through to Mullen on the near board. He put it in behind the goal. Kuchera swings it around and out to center. Doug Wilson, Biff flips it ahead. Herkes tried to center one. It didn't get to Mullen, however. Now Greg Gilbert cleared not out. And on the far side, Herkes across to Jason Moore, shooting. That is blocked by Chelios. Down to the near side. Chelios able to crank it off the boards and out. Knocked down again by a stick above the shoulder. And there's half a minute left on the Chicago penalty.
Gates, a second round pick of the North Stars. That's good skill for a big man, for a tough guy. And he's been utilized on the point in the power play.
And there they go. Whenever that Jaws soundtrack comes up. They go to the Shark Salute here in the Cow Palace. Now here's the draw in the San Jose zone, controlled by the Sharks, and Pat Balloon dumps it into the Hawk zone. Belfour fires it around the boards and out to center. Link Gates. Long feed to Balloon, a two-line pass. And the whistle sounds. Pat Falloon, we mentioned the second player picked in the draft this year when San Jose came into the league. The NHL made an interesting rule in which the new Shark team could not have the first pick. That went to the team that finished worst last year. So, of course, Lindros was drafted by Quebec. He's still not there, but Pat Falloon is really starting to make his mark in the NHL. He's in a difficult circumstance, and Dale, as you mentioned, with a team that has struggled as much as they have. They've brought him along slowly, and obviously the right thing to do. Matter of fact, now that the puck has dropped, number 9 on San Jose is Brian Lawton. He was the first player picked the year he came out in the draft. He was rushed into action by Minnesota, and he's never been the same since.
Well, I think the fact that it's an expansion team, it's a good situation for Falloon because there's no pressure on the team to win, and he can learn. This is like on-the-job training, but if you're with a quality team, a team that is expected to win, and you win into the fire and not perform well, then it's very difficult adjustment to make as far as a career.
Absolutely, and here is Brian Lawton to Jason Moore, who dumps it in. The Hawk penalty over. Both teams are at full strength. And now it's back in shark-infested waters as Doug Wilson. Shark-infested frozen waters, I should say. Wilson cleared it to center. Larmer there to Sutter over the line. In on McGill. Quick turn on the far side, trying to center. Nobody home for Chicago. And it's clear to the neutral zone. Goulet dumps it back in. Bouncing puck is gloved by Hackett. He'll hold it long enough for a whistle. It's early in period two in the Cow Palace. The San Jose Sharks won the Chicago Blackhawks.
Get ready for TVKO's February Fight of the Month. Merciless Ray Mercer versus Larry Holmes. Mercer's an undefeated heavyweight with 13 KOs. After his vicious knockout of Tommy Morrison, he's in line for the title. But now he faces a legend. Holmes is out to prove he's back as he faces his toughest challenge. One's coming on strong, one's coming back. The Last Stand, Power versus Pride, live on pay-per-view cable TV. Call your cable operator now to order this pay-per-view event.
This steak's as tough as a puck.
Some candlelight dining. And oh, by the way, a hockey game is going on. I wonder what, they must have some nice alfalfa sprouts and brie up there, don't they? Now, here's the draw, controlled by the Sharks. Wayne Pressly over the line to Bozek, shooting right on. Saved by Belfour, and he holds on.
seemed to hurt Belfour. He was in position, left no rebound, but quick pass from Presley to Bozak. Presley cuts through the middle. He's against the flow, back to the left side. Hit on target. Good save by Belfour.
The Red Wings played earlier tonight at home and won. Detroit 4, Washington 1. A goal and an assist for both Yzerman and Probert in the game. The Red Wings, with that victory, now move to 66 points. The Blackhawks open the action tonight with 58. Here's the draw, bouncing in the Hawk zone. Zettler held it into Fenton, whose pass came to Bozak. Quick move in the slot, got knocked down as he tried to shoot it. And Graham could clear it around the boards. It came loose to Zettler, a drive and a save by Belfour. Rebound lays there, and Belfour able to smother it. And a nice job by Cam Russell to clear the front of the net and prevent Presley from getting a rebound opportunity. Still early in period two, and still 1-0 Sharks.
This was me with dull gray hair. I looked washed up. Then I found a whole new way to make my gray look great.
Introducing a new kind of shampoo from the makers of Just for Men Hair Care, called Great Looking Gray. Great Looking Gray does more than clean and condition. It gets rid of the dullness. Even yellow buildup brings out the real silver.
What a difference it makes.
New Great Looking Gray shampoo. And for stubborn yellow, new Great Looking Gray anti-yellow treatment.
At Foliondale, Talon in the Cow Palace, 1-0 San Jose. As Steve Smith puts it into the Shark zone. Cuts into the corner. Now wrestling along the boards, and Tonelli held it into the near corner, and Hudson. Gates, oh, really gave him a face full of elbow. He's going to get a penalty. Now it's loose in front of the net. Tonelli wheels to the far side. John Tonelli tried to center it. Hudson had it taken away, and now as the Sharks control the whistle sound. A very aggressive elbow delivered by Link Gates will draw a penalty. Chicago to the power play, trailing 1-0.
In today's business climate, a luxury suite at Spectrum 2 is part of what it takes to be successful. Privacy and comfort of a suite makes you feel special. Service and the food are wonderful. And best of all, there's an incredible view of Flyers and Sixers action. My company just signed up for a suite in the new arena. It's good for our business and it's great fun. Whether you're interested in a suite or superbox seats, call today.
Gates for elbowing. What a vicious elbow on the head of Mike Hudson. Gets him right in the helmet. And off the glass, a penalty, an unnecessary penalty. At 3:50 of the second period, the Blackhawks get their third power play. They're 0-2 with the man advantage. We better get this power play working. Only three goals in this road trip.
Roenick got it to the side of the net where Larmer was knocked down, and the Sharks clear it. Now Jeremy Roenick leading Steve Larmer to center. Larmer gets the line, leaving for Smith on the near board. Steve Smith pounded by David Bruce. And Chelios able to keep it into Roenick, far circle. Back to the line, and Smith takes a look. Near point to Chelios. Deep slot to Smith. Scooped it over to Roenick, top of the ring. He shoots one, and he missed the net. Held in by Chelios. Put it in behind Goulet. Back to Chelios in the corner. Chris Chelios to Steve Larmer at the line, lets it go, and a save by Hackett. Rebound lays there. The Sharks are on it, and Bruce puts it around the boards. Not out. Good work by Smith to keep it in. Then he lost the handle, and the Sharks able to clear it down all the way.
Well, Hackett with a good save on that screenshot coming off the stick of Larmer. He didn't see it. He just stood there and had the puck hit him.
Brent Sutter back into the Shark zone for Graham on right wing. Sends it around the board. Bob Brown to the line. Russell bounced it back into the corner. Brown has it there, trying to center it to Flex, and the Sharks come out with it. Now, Evison Johnson over the hawk liner. Wrist shot and a save by Belfour. Rebound control by Brown. Bobby Brown to the San Jose line. Got spun around. Williams took it away. Clearing.
Well, Brown trying to take a dive to give the Blackhawks a two-man advantage, but Stewart wouldn't go for it.
Here's Brown back over the line, trying to center one. It hopped away from Sutter. And the Shark penalty is over. Both teams are back at full strength. Here comes Brian Mullen, two on one. Mullen over the line. Good play by Kachera to get in the passing lane. And the pass never did get to Gates. Now Graham gave it to Kachera. Long feed, a two-line pass to Rob Brown. And the whistle sounds.
Shark fans, be sure to vote.
6 minutes gone in the middle period, 1-0 San Jose.
Hollywood Pictures presents Sean Connery.
We need help.
Don't you presume to tell me how to follow up.
A man determined to make a difference.
I found a cure for the plague of the 20th century, and now I've lost it.
This is the cure for cancer.
I know. Now you move your road through here, and we've lost it.
From John McTiernan, the director of Die Hard and The Hunt for Red October. Medicine Man, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, February 7th at a theater near you.
Keenan trying to find some offense. One goal now for the Blackhawks in their last three starts. Power play really letting them down once again. Only three power play goals in this entire road trip.
And two came in one game. They were big ones in a come from behind effort in Edmonton, but other than that, it could be an unblemished road trip. The power play difficulties preventing that from happening. Here's a play in the Shark zone. Big hit in the corner delivered by Lemieux, who digs it out, tries the center. Gilbert put it in front. Hackett sweeps it aside to Presley. Then he gave it away to Hudson. Hudson against McGill in the corner. They go down. Then Lemieux dug it out, but his pass is stolen, and the Sharks come up with it. Paul Fenton, who's got this game's only goal, dumps it in. Now Smith. Back into the San Jose zone. On a drop pass to Chelios, and he did a nice job to tie up Presley, or Presley, who anticipated well, was off to the races.
A very dangerous place to attempt that drop pass.
Now in the neutral zone, Fenton. Run over by Roenick as he dumped it in there. Marchman comes out. And Marchman to Steve Larmer. Shooting it in, hoping for Goulet, who gets there, shoots, he scores! Michel Goulet on a perfect diagonal dump in from Steve Larmer. Goulet outworked his check, and it's career goal number 499. This game is tied at one.
Well, Goulet would not be denied there. Goulet getting a lot of ice time, more ice time probably in the first period than he's gotten in a lot of games throughout this road trip. He just broke down the left wing. Good read by Larmer, perfect dump in. Goulet shielded the puck, beautifully got in front of the defenseman, and then muscled it through Hackett into the net, and as Goulet went crashing to the ice after shoveling it past Hackett to tie it up. The goal coming at 7:22.
Michel Goulet's 12th of the year. Ties this game at 7:22. Larmer and Marchman get the assists. And now here's a two-on-one, and then Roenick left the puck behind. This ice really seems to be in bad shape in the Cow Palace. Twice now, Roenick could have had breaks, and the puck left his stick, which is uncharacteristic. Here's a centering pass. Belfour! What a save on Lawton! A terrific play by the Sharks, and Brian Lawton started to raise his stick. He was sure he had scored. Belfour with highway robbery.
Zettler carried the puck up the ice. Larmer looked like he had position on him, but Zettler eluded the check, got away from him, slipped it across to Lawton, and Belfour fully extended to his left, got the glove on it. Lawton thought he had scored. Good maneuver by Zettler to get away from a very dependable player. Larmer, great pass, and Lawton thought he had scored. Belfour jammed his glove up against the post and got a piece of it. Best save of the night. Belfour just got enough of it to deflect it wide and off the side of the net. He couldn't extend any further to his left to get that shot. Great flexibility by Ed Belfour. Save of the game.
He needed every last inch of that flexibility to go from post to post to make that stop. Face off to his left now. By the way, we gave you the Detroit score. They beat Washington 4-1. Toronto in overtime beats Minnesota 3-2. A Wendell Clark overtime goal to send the Maple Leafs to victory.
That was a very big goal for Toronto because Minnesota's able to tie it. They're still maintaining an 11-point lead over Toronto. Now it's down to 9.
Now the Sharks, Doug Wilson. Long feed, a two-line pass, and the whistle sound.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have
8 minutes gone to the second. Michelle Goulet's 499th time.
Make this the winter you learn to ski better with tips and techniques from ski's top teaching pros. Found in this all-new Ski Better Now video, yours free. Call this toll-free number today, and Ski Magazine will send you this video free with your paid subscription of only $11.94. Enjoy a full season of Ski Magazine, America's top-rated magazine for skiers. Beginner or expert, reach new levels of ability. Call today to get Ski Magazine, plus your free video, and ski better now.
27th consecutive sellout for these Sharks here at the Cow Parlor.
Go Sharks!
I think that's more of an appropriate name for this place. 10,088.
Looks a lot better than when you used to come in here, doesn't it?
It smells a lot better, too.
The plays in the Hog Zone. Kuchera had some trouble in the corner. Now Lemieux along the board. It's wrapped up by Evason, but it's cleared to center, and McGill shoots it right back in. Kuchera put it to the near side, held it by Wilson, and a whistle.
For what?
Off the play for some reason.
No one knows why.
Delayed offside, I believe, is the call. Speaking of former Chicago players, there's also an ex-Chicago coach, Bob Murdoch, the assistant coach here for George Kingston.
But you can't run as far as Kingston.
Who can?
He runs those 100-mile marathons or whatever.
52-year-old George Kingston, he does ultra marathons. And doing them around here, of course, there are a lot of hills. He's really quite an interesting fellow, George Kingston. 20 years at the University of Calgary. Now, NHL head coach with an expansion team going through the many growing pains that there are in the early years of a franchise. Here's Steve Smith deep in his own end. Give it to Chris Chelios. Up the left side to Goulet. And his feed broken up. Now the Hawks trying to dump it in. Can't get it through. Fenton over the line, but San Jose offside in the play.
Puck bouncing all over the place as this game wears on. And very important to have the lead, I would think, because a lot of funny things can happen. And a 1-1 hockey game. Hawk fans join Jeremy Roenick and some of his teammates on Monday the 10th from 7 to 9 at the Wilmette Ice Arena. They will perform on-ice clinic for Wilmette youth hockey players. Admission is free, and so is the raffle. They're also giving away items. So join JR and the Hawks Monday at the Wilmette Ice Arena in Glenview. Does that make sense? Wilmette Ice Arena should be in Wilmette.
Maybe they changed the boundary. Here's Rob Brown.
I should read him before I did.
It's on Glenview Road, I can tell you that. Now, here's the puck at the side of the Shark net. And it's held out there for a whistle.
Maybe the rink's half in Wilmette, half in Glenview. Should be an interesting night for all you youngsters that are interested in hockey. And Jeremy Roenick, obviously a big hit in the Chicago area, having a great year. Out there and get some free pointers. A lot of hockey fans, or a lot of Chicago Blackhawk fans in the area. A lot of jerseys here, a lot of red, white, and black jerseys. A lot of old Oakland Seal fans, too. Those jerseys are getting a little discolored.
The colorful of Charlie Finley, of course, was he was the first owner of that team, wasn't he? I think that he had them in white skates, I remember, one year, didn't he?
Well, he wasn't the first owner, but he did want them to wear white skates, and he wanted also the puck to be changed to an orange, fluorescent orange, so that people could view it better on television.
There's the play in the neutral zone. Jocelyn Lemieux puts it into the San Jose end. It's going to be an icing call against Chicago. We're halfway through the second period, and the Hawks and the Sharks are tied at one.
When sports scream, when arms are sore, when legs ache, when muscles hurt, why sports scream? Massaging Sports Cream In brings fast pain relief. No medicine-y smell, no odor. Why sports scream? Because it works.
Athlete's foot. Every year, over 28 million Americans get it. Try NP27. Its doctor-recommended ingredient stops burning and itching fast. NP27. Nothing's a better cure for athlete's foot.
The Sharks' Finn on top of the Zamboni. Sharks had a couple of accidents here in the Cow Palace. Digging into the ice a little deeper than he should. Must have been a blood stain on the ice.
Face-off will be to the right of Ed Belfour. And it's controlled by the Hawks' Kuchera. Gave it to Goulet. Shooting it in. Got Wilson. Leaves it for Bob McGill. And McGill bounces one to center, Barry Anderson. Oh, he stood right up by Marchman, and Anderson trying to get his breath back after Brian Marchman had it, saw him with his head down and made him pay the price.
Well, that's an excellent hit by Marchman on Anderson, who's played briefly with St. Louis and New Jersey. Good hang time on that flip out by McGill. Landed in the neutral zone. Turned, Barry Anderson, I should say, got hit hard by Marchman. Got a piece of his left leg. Anderson's a very solid, sturdy player, and it takes more than that to keep him out of the remainder of this game.
Now the draw, Brent Sutter into the Shark zone, shooting, and he shot it wide from a tough angle. Steve Smith at the line with a long shot. That didn't get through. And now on the near side, Sutter tries to center. Williams stole it, but couldn't get it out. Into the far corner goes Brown. Kicks it loose to Graham in behind. He stood up there by Zettler. And Rob Zettler came up with it for San Jose. The Pat Falloon on right wing. Got around Brent Sutter. Gets over the line. Falloon for Lawton. A diving play by Chelios to block the pass. And then Zettler fanned on it. Now there's going to be a Hawk penalty, and Chicago controls. The whistle sounds. And a couple of near misses for San Jose in the Chicago end of the ice.
A good play by Falloon. You better take the body on the youngster. He's very tricky. He got around one check at the line. Tried to make the pass across. Chelios made a good play. Falloon with the bouncing puck. Slips it by Sutter. Sutter flat-footed that time. Didn't get Falloon or the puck. Falloon taking a look. Chelios, great play. Falloon continues on and then got it up front. Zettler just missed clicking on the pass and then had his feet taken down from him, and Steve Smith gets a penalty well off the play. His second penalty of the night, and the San Jose Sharks will get their fourth power play of the night, a power play that is 0 for 3.
Now the faceoff to the right of Belfour. Here's the draw to Larmer. Steve Larmer works his way to the San Jose line. Finally in traffic, it's taken away. Doug Wilson. Pounded by Larmer behind the net. They both go down, and now the Sharks come up with it. Here's a 3-on-2 break over the line. Bruce shooting, and a save by Belfour. Rebound to the far side. Held in. Here's Mullen centering. Wilson fired. Belfour well out of the net to challenge Doug Wilson's blast. Wilson got all of it, and Belfour not only stopped it, he gave no rebound.
Well, Jeremy Roenick's upset, rightfully so. He's yanked down deep in the Shark zone. That resulted in a 3-on-2. Good save by Belfour on Herkus, and then another good save on Wilson. The pass out front. Wilson left alone, moves in, head down. Belfour moves out of the net. He's moving forward. The shot hits him, and no rebound. Larmer, with a good job of forechecking on his former teammate Wilson, gets the puck loose. Wilson sent to the ice, so did Larmer, but Roenick had a chance to get to a loose puck, was yanked down, no penalty call. And then the Sharks counter with a good play, good save on Herkus by Belfour, and then another equally good save on Doug Wilson. Second quality chance of the night for Wilson as he's been left alone. You give him time and room, sooner or later he's going to make you pay. Wilson with 233 goals in his career.
Here's another long shot from Wilson, stopped by Belfour, and the Hawks able to clear it. Now Link Gates dumping it in. There's a chop at it coming through to the near side as Dirk Graham starts back. Graham into the Shark zone. Wilson took it away from him. Doug Wilson shoots it in. Belfour bounces it, not out. Now came loose to Lawton, top of the near circle. Into the corner, Falloon. Back to Lawton along the boards. He got away from Sutter, trying to center one, bouncing puck corralled by the Sharks. Now Falloon, side of the net, trying to work, walk in front. Good poke check by Belfour to save himself a chance. And the Hawks then clear it. Lawton back over the Hawk line, centering the pass through to the far side. Bruce there, gave it away to Marchment. He clears it down all the way. Here's a bad play by Hackett. He gave it away to Hudson, who tries to center. Here's Cam Russell shooting. Big save by Hackett, who bailed himself out after a bad play. Now the Sharks move back. Bruce, offside, or is there a penalty behind the play? That's what it is, Paul Stewart. Getting Link Gates for a penalty well behind the play as the Sharks were moving up the ice. So we have 6.5 left in the second. We're tied at 1.
Oh no, my hair's not only going gray, now it's getting thinner. I wish they made something for gray thinning hair.
They have Grecian Plus. Grecian Plus is a fresh-smelling foam that gradually brings back natural-looking color, the famous Grecian way. But this Grecian has a big plus. It builds body for healthier, fuller-looking hair.
Your hair looks great. Feels thicker, too.
Grecian Plus, the total treatment for gray, thinning hair.
Jeff Hackett with the puck behind his net, takes a look and then gives it to Hudson. He looked to see who was coming, saw him, gave it to him. The pass was intended in front. Russell with a good move, gets it by the defenseman, cranks it up. Excellent save by Hackett with the left pad. Meanwhile, Link Gates away from the play gets a holding call. And the Blackhawks will go back to the power play for the fourth time. Sharks are 0-for-4. Gates, the second trip here in this period. First one was for elbowing, this one for holding at 13-19. Looks like a choir boy, Link Gates, doesn't he? I think he would always be in the back row, though, of the choir. Throwing spitballs at him.
Link has had a myriad of problems, and Sharks do think that he could be a talent if he...
does have good skills.
He does. Just mentioned it before, a big guy, very tough, and has shown some good skills this season, and they're hoping he'll be able to maintain the good attitude and outlook that he's had most of the time this season. There's the puck cleared down by the Sharks, the length of the ice. And the Hawk power play with another opportunity here, this time to get in the lead. Jeremy Roenick shooting it in. Goulet gets to it in the corner, threw it across to the near side, and Larmer lost the handle. Smith pinching to keep it in there, and it's held along the boards for a whistle.
Smith and Chelios once again getting a lot of ice time. Hawks basically going with four defensemen. Rod Buskus had a good first period, had a couple of quality chances, and not seeing the ice, I don't believe, here in the second period.
18 shots for San Jose so far in the game. 14 for Chicago. And this is what? Third, fourth power play?
Fourth power play. Sharks have had four as well.
Not a lot being generated with the Hawk power play again tonight. Maybe they can change it here. Teixeira to the far side and Sutter. Brent Sutter looks along the boards and gave it a Graham side of the net, trying to slip it in front of bouncing puck is kicked at, controlled by San Jose and cleared to center ice. Chelios right back over the line, got away from McGill, trying to cut it, and Presley moved across to knock it off his stick. In behind the net, it's taken by Chelios. Centering Owen Brown and Graham unable to connect. Now Chelios in the deep slot. Far board to Kuchera. To Graham on that side. Leaves it there for Sutter. Shooting. Hackett, a stand-up save, and he goes down trying to cover it. He didn't. Hawks jam it loose to Marchman. He moves it into the corner, and Sutter. Brent Sutter along the far side. Sutter, top of the ring, side of the net to Graham. Wilson goes down. Graham got around him. Shooting. Hackett, the same rebound round. And that shot deflects inches wide. Now Sutter to the line of Kuchera. His pass deflected, stolen by the Sharks. And Presley back over the Hawk line. Lost the handle. Back comes Hudson, racing in there. Hudson to Brown, fires, Hackett the save. And he holds on. And now Brown and Presley, I believe, got the sticks high. Presley and Brown unhappy with one another. The linesmen very alertly jump in there between them.
Shift for Rob Brown on the power play, gets a couple of good chances. Dirk Graham waits. Doug Wilson tries to sprawl. Graham drifts away from the wrist shot. The rebound hacked at by Brown. Off the blocker and up over to the left of Hackett. Good save there on Brown. And then on a countering play, as the Sharks were changing, so were the Hawks. Drop pass Hudson to Brown, and Brown just drifted one with Lemieux cutting in front. Hackett again makes the save. Then after the whistle, Presley and Brown collided. They get into a shoving match. A lot of conversation, but no penalties. With 4:41 to go here in the second period in a 1-1 hockey game. Hawks are 1 second away from going 0 for 4 with the man advantage, though. They've generated a few chances on this one. Shot by Graham and two shots by Rob Brown.
Face off to the left of Jeff Hackett. Hudson got the draw to Marchman along the boards. His long shot and a save by Hackett. Rebound at the side of the net, and Hackett covers it there as the Shark penalty expires. And both teams are back at full strength.
Hawks doing a better job this period of faceoffs. They win the faceoff. Marchman, just as the player was coming to the box, got the puck, got it away just in time, right on target. Mike Hudson winning the draw. Marchman lets it rip. Marchman playing the right point on target and then kicked at by Hudson, and Hackett, as he fell to his back, was able to prevent the puck from crossing the line.
So again, they're ready in the San Jose zone, and the Hawks get this draw as well. Marchman, a long shot, missing the net, and Ryan Mullen chipped it away to Bruce. Can have a two-on-one, feeds ahead. Here's a chance for Herkes. Good pull, the trigger.
Sharks, a poor pinch in along the boards. The puck squirted by. A two-on-one situation. Herkes breaking in on the near wing. Puck comes around the boards. Russell pitches in. Lemieux doesn't catch up to it. Hawks get caught. Herkes on the feed from Bruce. Herkes fakes, goes around the net. Belfour overplays it. Herkes makes the pass behind Belfour, and it's tucked in the empty net by Bruce.
Three Hawks behind the goal line extended when this puck went in the net. And it's 2-1 San Jose. Chelios in the Chicago end cleared it back into the San Jose zone. Herkes and Mullen get the assists on Bruce's goal. It's 15:38. Now it's in the Shark end. Goulet in the near corner. Michel Goulet knocked down behind the net. Falloon came out of there with it. Pat Falloon on right wing and center. Galt's into the Blackhawk zone, and Chelios sends it back the other way. Wilson will have to play it. Doug Wilson sends it up the near side. Falloon got it to center. Over the line, McGill stick handling, shoots one, and a save by Belfour. Rebound taken by Roenick. Now to Goulet. He dumps it in, hoping for Graham, racing after it. Graham got to it on the far side with the puck flopping. Then he got it to Sutter. And Wilson poke checked it away from him. Sutter to the near corner, put it in behind. Here's Rob Brown, a backhander. That's blocked by McGill, who went sprawling in front of that to get the shot blocked. Brown got it back. Brown to the slot, kicked into the stick, knocked down as he tried to shoot it. And Wilson able to clear it back to center ice. And it's a very spirited San Jose team here tonight, as you would have expected, with the Hawks coming in and a lot of former Chicago people involved with this team now. And here's a dump in winding up in the crowd.
This has been an excellent hockey game. It's gotten better with every shift. And the Sharks bounce right back after Goulet tied it up. They take the lead and into it. Action in a fast-paced game with only 2:45 left in the second period. And the Chicago fan getting a puck that was dumped in by Doug Wilson.
That's our friend that sits behind us at Chicago Stadium. And I wonder if he's throwing peanuts on the people that are sitting in front of him tonight.
He's in the front row tonight.
Yeah, that's
right. Up there in the second or first balcony, I should say. Sharks making a lot of money. It's just unfortunate the original franchise in Oakland wasn't on this side. They didn't have the franchise in San Francisco. It'd still be here. It would have been a big success.
Well, not only does San Jose have the Sharks coming down there in 2 years, there's a chance that the San Francisco Giants might move down to San Jose as well. There's a big vote going to be taken about that. Here's a chance for the Hawks, and a man taken down. There'll be a penalty coming up as Mike Hudson, working hard in the Shark zone, got yanked to the ice. And a penalty will come against David Williams, I believe.
Hawks really more aggressive in this second period, too. They've taken the body, and that resulted in their only goal, and they almost get their second one. A lot of banging and crashing here. Two Hawk players go after the outstanding free agent acquisition, David Williams. Williams takes down Hudson, though, as he attempted a wraparound. He goes to the box.
2 minutes for holding at 17:37.
Williams went to school at Dartmouth, was a teammate of Tom Finks at Dartmouth. Well, certainly Williams did not learn anything from Tom Finks.
I was waiting. I knew you weren't finished. I think Tommy Finks taught this kid everything he knows about this game of hockey. And that's why he's in the NHL. And that's why I'm going to get real good press notes when I get back home. Now here's the play in the Sharks zone. Not for long. It's cleared down all the way. So the Blackhawks with another power play chance here.
The fifth one of the night. They're 0 for 4.
Chris Chelios sends Goulet up the right wing board. He gets the line, stopping, trying to center it too far for Larmer. Smith to the corner. Put it around the boards, Larmer. Out to the near point, and Chelios. He walks along the line with it, now tees it up and shoots one. Hackett, a good pass, save. Rebound back to Roenick. He stick handles, dropping to Chelios. Now Smith along the far side of the corner. Looks for Larmer, and he loots into Chelios. Shooting. Hackett the save. And he deflected it over the glass into the crowd.
Well, Hackett made a really good save on the first shot, and then on that wicked shot by Chelios. Guy slid in front of Chelios. He had to put it high. Puck in the corner. Smith tries to get it to Larmer into Chelios. Chelios sees the defenseman Zettler slide in front. Tries to go high, but Hackett standing up. Does not go down. Hit him in the shoulder and deflected up high into the seats. Well, we saw Hackett last year with the Islanders. He had a brilliant performance against the Blackhawks at the Chicago Stadium. And playing very well tonight, very cool in the nets. Standing up well on that save.
Face off in the Shark zone. Taken by Smith to Chelios near point. There's a minute to go in the Hawk power play as Chelios shoots and stop. Rebound in front. Brown hacking at it. Couldn't get it through. Hackett. And now Hackett wants to freeze it and does.
Boy, Rob Brown's had three great chances in this period from point blank range. And each time Hackett has been there, that time it looked like Hackett was going to be down, but Hackett staying up on the first shot by Chelios. And then Brown on the rebound. Graham hacks at it, comes to Brown. Brown just in too close, couldn't put it over the left pad. A little Jeff Hackett. Then he paid the price as he was hit hard into the end boards by Doug Wilson. Brown looking for his first goal as a Blackhawk. Just a matter of time. Had an assist in his very first game. And that's it.
Face off to the left to Hackett. Here's the draw to Chelios. Chelios to the deep slot, moves it across to Smith. Now on the near board, Brown. Into the corner, Sutter cuts in center. Roenick, he scores! What a release by Jeremy Roenick. A nice soft pass by Brent Sutter, and Jeremy Roenick buried it by the stick side of Hackett. The Hawks come through on the power play and have tied the game at two.
Well, you couldn't do it any better than that. Brown with the puck along the far side. Good work by Smith and Chelios. Touch pass from Chelios to Brown along the near boards. Into Sutter at the corner. Sutter goes to the corner, deep slot. Roenick finally someone in the slot moving forward, moving towards the puck, and the one-timer just under the crossbar and in the net. Perfect passing all around. Touch pass from Chelios. Brown into Sutter. Sutter to Roenick, who finishes it from the slot.
39th goal of the year for Jeremy Roenick. His 17th on the road. And Sutter and Brown get the assist at 18:56, and the Hawk power play. And long last comes through in an important situation.
That's a very big goal, too. Don't forget, this is the third game in 4 days for the Sharks. They played Sunday afternoon in Winnipeg. They played last night here at home against Hartford in a hard-fought battle. And that goal, if the Sharks win with a one-goal lead, they'll be more optimistic, obviously, but that late goal could be the difference.
In the Chicago zone, Mullen dropped it back. Williams shoots, and he scores! David Williams, a shot from the top of the far circle, and only moments after the Hawks tie it, San Jose is back in front, 3-2.
I don't know what happened with that shot. Looked like it knuckled the pass across. Banked off the far boards through the deep slot, through the slot area in front of the Hawk net. Swatted at by Russell. Hurkacz, I believe, hacked it across. And Williams, a defensive specialist with a knuckler, that seemed to drop. Puck was on edge and it seemed to dip and beat Belfour to the stick side. Belfour looked like he was going to play it off the blocker and it just went right under it. But Bruce has got one leg in the crease and according to the new rule, should be no goal. But well, I think it's going to be allowed. We've seen goals just allowed for less than that in the crease, and clearly Bruce had his foot in the crease. But the play continues on. But that puck knuckled pass, it looked like it curved away. It looked like Belfour was going to have it on the blocker, and it went right under and into the net with Bruce having one foot in the crease. Was his foot in the crease before the puck went in the net? That's the question. Williams' second goal in the NHL, second goal of the year.
Bruce and Hurkacz get the assists at 19-19, and that goal should not be allowed. The video replay official here ought to be calling down to Paul Stewart to say he wants to take a look. A man's foot was clearly in the crease when that puck went in the net, and there was no Hawk pushing him in there. Here comes Lawton. Lawton over the Hawk line, cuts in, shooting, and a save by Belfour. Rebound taken by Rob Brown, and that's going to do it for the second period. Sharks and the Hawks each score twice in the second, and San Jose will take a lead into the third.
Blackhawks trailing the San Jose Sharks 3-2 at the end of two periods of play. The last goal somewhat controversial as it looked like one of the Sharks was in the crease, but for now it's standing 3-2. The Sharks have the lead at the end of two periods of play. It was 1-0 San Jose as we began the period. The Blackhawks strike first in the second. Michel Goulet, his 499th career goal, is 12th of the season. That tied the game up at 1-1. No more scoring until the 15:38 mark of the third period when the San Jose Sharks come up with one. David Bruce is going to come up with his 15th goal of the year, beating Ed Belfour. And a nice pass from Tony Hercus. 2-1, the Sharks had the lead. Then with just about a minute left to play in the second period, the Blackhawks on the power play. Jeremy Roenick is 39th of the year, and the game was tied up at 2-2. But just 23 seconds later, the Sharks strike again and take the lead again. David Williams, his second NHL goal. That gave the Sharks the 3-2 lead, and that's where we stand at the end of two periods of play from the Cow Palace. The assist on Williams' goal go to Bruce and Hercus at the 19-19 mark. As for shots on goal in the second period, at the end of one period of play, each team had 10 shots on. Well, there's the rest of the scoring summary. Larmer and Marchman getting the assist on Goulet's goal. Tony Hercus getting the assist on Bruce's goal as well. So Hercus had two assists in the second period. Now taking a look at the shots on goal through two periods of play. As I mentioned, it was tied up 10-10 at the end of one period. In the second period, Hawks had the better of it, 16-11. The total for the game, 26-21. But at the end of two periods of play, San Jose leading the Chicago Blackhawks by a score of 3-2. We'll take a tour around the league when we come back.
T-minus 10 seconds and counting. T-minus 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition, we have liftoff.
Get ready to launch yourself into the world of Air and Space Smithsonian, a world that captivates the imagination. Satellites, superjets, soaring, something different every other month.
This is Starbird. Booster separation.
There's no other magazine like Air and Space Smithsonian. Call now and subscribe to a full year of fun, excitement, and mind-boggling photographs. And with your subscription comes membership in the National Air and Space Museum in Washington. So begin your countdown by calling now.
This is Starbird. Permission to use your phone?
To order Air and Space Smithsonian Magazine, call 800-841-0300 and receive a $18 with membership in the National Air and Space Museum. Call 800-841-0300 now.
I needed a change of scenery, so I left Wall Street for 2 years and got a job in Africa with the Peace Corps. We've started a development program for local businessmen. You won't find them on the exchange, but we have our share of success stories. Helping Jomo get a loan to motorize his fishing boat has tripled his catch and meant more food and jobs for everyone. It's proved to me that investing in good people provides great dividends.
Peace Corps, the toughest job you'll ever love.
2 years ago, this car was the most important thing in Joey's life. He spent every dime he had on it. He even quit school to get a job so he could have the hottest ride in town. Today, the job is gone, the car doesn't work anymore, and without a high school diploma, neither does Joey.
At the moment, the Blackhawks and the Sharks, one of only two games still going in the NHL. Everything else is a final, and the big one as far as the Hawks are concerned. Detroit, a 4-1 winner over Washington tonight. Steve Yzerman is red hot for the Red Wings. Toronto, a winner over Minnesota. The final 3-2 in overtime. Wendell Clark gets the game winner. Rangers over Pittsburgh, 4-3. Brian Trottier with 2 points tonight. He now has 14,000 for his career. The other game still going on is in Calgary. The Flames on their way to a victory over the Quebec Nordiques. And Edmonton, a winner at home over Montreal. The Oilers have won 4 of their last 5. When we come back after this timeout, we're going to have a feature on the first NHL team in the Bay Area, the California Golden Seals. Stay with us. Blackhawks trail 3-2 at the end of 2.
He's a man's man who knows what a woman likes.
I'd like more.
He's the one and only Bogart.
He's looking at you, kid.
Call this number now and enjoy a nostalgic look back at one of Hollywood's all-time biggest stars in this extraordinary video library, the Bogart Collection. Get Humphrey Bogart in all his classic films.
Hip, hip, hooray!
I'm a private dick on a case.
Spade. That's P-A-D-E.
You haven't got nerve enough to pull the trigger while I'm looking you straight in the eye.
Begin the romance with Casablanca. For the introductory price of $9.99, keep this story of love and intrigue, and another Bogart movie will follow every 6 weeks at the regular price, each in a deluxe collector's case. Don't miss the fabulous Bogart Collection from Time Life Video.
To order your Casablanca video, use your credit card and call 1-800-841-0300 or send just $9.99 plus $3.23 shipping to the address on your screen.
fascination always existed. The human body, without doubt, is the greatest of inventions. Flawless in design, capable of astonishing feats. Amazingly, the harder the body is worked, the stronger, more beautiful it becomes. To unlock your body's potential, we proudly offer Soloflex. 32 old-fashioned iron-pumping exercises, each correct in form and balance. All on a machine that fits in the corner of your home. Soloflex, simple and efficient, like the body itself. Which may explain why it looks less like a machine and more like a work of art. For a free brochure, call anytime.
Got a little overzealous on Brian Trottier. He doesn't play in the NBA where you can score 14,000 points. He's, of course, only got 1,400. We tacked on one too many zeros. Now that the Sharks have infested the Bay Area, some of the memories of the old California hockey team are starting to fade. The California / Oakland / California Golden Seals entered the NHL in 1967 during the league's first major expansion. The Seals remained on the scene until 1976 when they went off to Cleveland. Sports Channel's Mike Emmerich takes a look back at the only professional sports team that changed their nickname three times without even changing their arena.
The mists of time do not obscure the history of hockey in the San Francisco Bay Area. Many of us recall an era 25 years ago when the Oakland Seals entered the NHL. For those involved, expansion hockey was both a thrill and a struggle.
Well, of course, I was real young at the time, it was my first chance to play in the National Hockey League, and of course, that's what I wanted to do all my life. And what I can remember is, you know, I really enjoyed it. Of course, as you can see, the weather here right now, that's basically what the weather is during the hockey season, too. So there are a lot of things that you can do besides play hockey, of course, and you can play golf, tennis, all the outdoor sports all year round, and I think that basically held back the fans in the Oakland area when we had the team because we weren't winning. And then all of a sudden the draft came along and the World Hockey League came along and we lost half the players. So the nucleus that we had in Oakland was really, really good, and I think we could have been a contender, but it just fell apart.
In six out of their 9 years, the Oakland Seals, or later the California Golden Seals, finished last. Not exactly the Seals of approval.
It kind of wears on you, you know. You go to the rink and, you know, it's just not a one-man game. 18, 20 of us play it, and gets a little disheartening after you, you know, go on the road and lose about 15 in a row and come home and think, okay, things are going to change around. All of a sudden, you lose five or six more, and you go into a tailspin and lose 20 games. It is tough, it's a little tough to go to the rink, but once you get that one win under your belt, you think, okay, here it comes. And but when you only win 20 games a year, it is real, real tough.
Ernie Hickey was a member of the California Golden Seals in the early 70s. In those days, Bobby Orr was revolutionizing hockey, and Hickey and his teammates found out firsthand how Orr could take over a game.
I can remember, for instance, we were playing in Oakland. We were ahead 6-0 going into the second period, and we just overheard the conversation through one of our stick boys, and Orr had said in the dressing room that they weren't going to lose. We came out and scored 2 goals. They scored 9 in that period to beat us 9-8. He got 4 goals and 5 assists.
From the legendary to the trivial, Hickey remains, with Guy Lafleur, the answer to one of hockey's best trivia questions. In 1970, the Seals acquired Hickey by trading the rights to the first overall draft choice to Montreal. That turned out to be Guy Lafleur.
It really doesn't bother me. You know, it's kind of, I shouldn't say it's a pat on the back to me, but I think, you know, Guy Lafleur, again, is in a class all of his own. And for me to be traded, or the draft choice was traded for me, I kind of smile when somebody says it to me, but I think that Montreal got the better end of the deal, that's for sure.
You may recognize number 27, Gilles Meloche, for the California Golden Seals. He got traded to California because he just couldn't move past a guy named Tony Esposito here in Chicago. When we come back, Pat and Dale will have their analysis of the short timeout. The Blackhawks trail the Sharks 3-2 at the end of two.
Baseball has been around for over 150 years. That's why the Postal Service honored America's game with its very own stamp in 1939. And now you can honor past and present players with the official Major League Baseball postage stamps. These are genuine stamps featuring 80 of the greats in the game. Andre Dawson, Daryl Strawberry, Wade Boggs, along with 300-game winner Nolan Ryan. Catch all your favorite stars in this stunning Baseball Collector's Edition containing 80 official stamps. You also get this deluxe 64-page hardcover album that details the history of baseball. Regular price is normally $29.95, but this special offer is only $19.95 for the premier issue of Major League Baseball in stamps.
With your credit card order of the baseball stamps for $19.95, you will be able to receive a set of three commemorative Desert Storm envelopes for an additional $10.50. For every Desert Storm order, $1 will be donated to the Red Cross. Call today, 1-800-762-1150. That's 1-800-762-1150.
If you could be the executive producer, would you choose this event or this event? With the Olympics Triple Cast, you'll get 24-hour coverage for 15 days on three cable channels. So now, for the 92 Barcelona Olympics, you can choose your event. Call today. The Olympics Triple Cast, a whole new way to see the games.
Make this the winter you learn to ski better with tips and techniques from ski's top teaching pros. Found in this all-new Ski Better Now video, yours free. Call this toll-free number today, and Ski Magazine will send you this video free with your paid subscription of only $11.94. Enjoy a full season of Ski Magazine, America's top-rated magazine for skiers. Beginner or expert, reach new levels of ability. Call today to get Ski Magazine, plus your free video, and Ski...
The Blackhawks have never had the lead in this hockey game. They tied it up 2-2 late in the period, but the Sharks came back with a quick goal to make it 3-2. For the analysis of the second period, let's go back to the Cow Palace to Pat Foley and Dale Talon.
Thank you very much, Jim Blaney. This is a very spirited San Jose team we're playing, we're seeing tonight, and we knew that there would be a lot of Hawk players, ex-Hawks, very excited. Their teammates also picking it up.
Well, they're coming off a big win last night. They're very confident, and it's been a low-scoring game. They've had the lead most of the game, and they're playing with more enthusiasm as the game goes on. But the Blackhawks had another edge in play at even strength. Finally did score on the power play. Good work along the blue line. You see how high the penalty killers are. They're not really showing a lot of respect for the shots, so they're putting pressure on them. And then great passing. Brown to Sutter, and Sutter the pinpoint accurate pass, and a great one-timer by Roenick. It looked like the Blackhawks were going to be on their way. That tied the game at 18:56. But 23 seconds later, good work by Drews. Perkis across ice. It bounces off the far boards. The defenseman Williams comes in. The puck knuckles and drops. Belfour misplayed it under the blocker and in the net. Drews was in the crease, but they let it go. They got away with one. And the Sharks have the lead once again. So the Blackhawks are going to have to come from behind, and I think they will. I think they're played very well. It's just a matter of time before their offense starts to click.
Once again, Dale the Greek giving the predictions that he's become so good at and so known for. He's hoping the Sharks come from behind. He's calling it that they will. It's 3-2 San Jose after two.
The best performing portfolios of the 90s will have a key new ingredient you need to know. The state of Virginia's retirement fund just added $100 million of this new element, and they're planning for up to $500 million more. It's not stocks, bonds, or real estate. It's managed futures accounts, the newest asset class. Whether you have a financial advisor or you make your own investment decisions, you need this book on adding managed futures to your portfolio. A $10 value free from the Investment Club. Dial 1-800-4-MA-BOOK now. It's filled with charts, tables, mathematical formulas, and much, much more. During the last 10 years, managed futures investment volume has grown from $500 million to $20 billion and could top $50 billion by the end of the 90s. Most financial advisors agree that sooner or later, managed futures accounts will be in every portfolio. Get your free book now on adding managed futures to your portfolio. Call 1-800-4-MA-BOOK.
Hi, I'm Lorenzo Quinn. I've been telling you about incredible opportunities now opening up to collectors of authentic, limited edition prints signed by Salvador Dali. Since his passing in 1989, the value of many of his works have proven to be an intelligent acquisition. That is why, in collaboration with the Salvador Dalí Archives, this full-color catalog was created that contains over 350 of Dalí's greatest limited edition prints. It is an indispensable guide to anyone interested in documented, authentic print works of Salvador Dalí. So whether you are an established collector or just thinking of getting started, I urge you to call now for information on how to acquire this important catalog. Every caller will receive a free copy of the Salvador Dalí Collector's Newsletter with all the latest information about exhibits, auctions, price trends, and much, much more. It's a $10 value, absolutely free, no obligation. So please call 1-800-4-DALÍ. Thank you.
The NHL is exclusively on Sports Channel. Our next league game tomorrow at 9:30, live from the Great Western Forum. The Kings will host the Whalers exclusively on Sports Channel. And a reminder, you can catch sports at 15 and 45 past each hour on WBBM News Radio 78. I think I'll take this mascot home for Lauren and Kristen. Fun here at the Cow Parlor. Blackhawks looking to come from behind, though, for only the second time this year. They're 1-18-1 when trailing after two. Sharks are 7-1-2 and leading. And here's the draw now, controlled by the Hawks as they dump it into the Shark zone. Hackett played it to Wilson. He flipped it out to center. Chelios steps right back over the Shark line, threw it into the near corner. Sutter poked it behind the net. Graham after it there. Wilson gave him a rough ride to the corner. And Bob McGill able to pick it up there. Clearing it out to center. Here's Bozek over the Hawk line trying to cut for the net. Rob Brown diving, a shot. He scores! Belfour made a first save, but the puck came loose, and Paul Fenton scores his second goal of the game. San Jose with their biggest lead now. It's 4-2.
Well, Fenton just outfought Chelios that time for position. Looked like Chelios relaxed. Nice touch pass by Wayne Pressly. Up the middle to Bozek. Bozek goes wide. Brown dives with Bozek with the backhander off the blocker. And Fenton just outworks. Chelios gets position on him and puts it into the net to give the Sharks a two-goal lead. Well, Pressly gets his second assist. Great touch pass to spring Bozek. And Fenton scores his second of the night and third in two games.
Paul Fenton has 8 goals all year, 2 tonight. He scored the winner last night. And it's a 4-2 Shark lead. Here's Kuchera in behind the San Jose goal, centering Goulet, shooting, Hackett! Big save as Goulet had him to himself. Here's a San Jose steal, and Mullen cuts over the line with a backhander. Belfour squeezing the pads together to make the save. And a little pushing and shoving for a moment, but no further developments as Chelios and Bruce separate.
Well, Goulet almost got his milestone goal. Good save by Hackett. Goulet looking for his second of the game. Gets away from his check. Moves into the hash marks. Waits, got a stick on the ice, off the skate, and then snapped it. Tried to go low to the stick side. And Hackett, as we've seen all night long, standing up, playing the angle, not going down, not committing early. And he's had a strong performance. 28 shots he's faced, 16 of them in the second period.
Now it's in the Hawk zone. Gates tries to center, bounces through to the near corner, and Smith. Dave Smith around the boards to Rob Brown. Long feed. Hudson couldn't quite hang on. Then Lemieux carries on. Jocelyn Lemieux shooting it in. Gates clearing it, not out. He got a big hit from Lemieux after he cleared it. Now here's Lemieux, a shot. And Gates ran the stick right through the legs of Lemieux after he shot it. The play goes on. Into the near corner, kick loose to Smith, cutting in front to his backhand, shoots Hackett, and then the rebound cleared just wide. Now on the near board, the Sharks able to come up with it. And Rogers bounces it into the Chicago zone.
Well, Mike Peluso, an empty net rebound chance after Steve Smith went in all alone on the backhand.
Brad Lauer into the Shark zone. He's knocked down. Sutter to the corner after it. He's tied up there. Now Lauer. Had it knocked loose to the far side. Rob Brown put it in behind to Lauer. Lauer rolled it in front. Sutter couldn't get to it. Now Brown does. He fakes, walks into the slot, shooting. Packett with a right hand, made a good save. And the Hawks hold it in. Then Kuchera's shot goes wide. And the Sharks able to clear it the other way. Mike Sullivan just taking an icing call here. Under some good Chicago pressure, but Jeff Hackett again coming up big in the Shark goal. It's early in the third. It's 4-2 San Jose.
When sports scream, when arms are sore, when legs ache, when muscles hurt, why sports scream? Massaging Sports Cream In brings fast pain relief. No medicine-y smell, no odor. Why sports scream? Because it works.
Athlete's foot. Every year, over 28 million Americans get it. Try NP27. Its doctor-recommended ingredient stops burning and itching fast. NP27. Nothing's a better cure for athlete's foot.
Looks like the Blackhawks are upset with the situation. They should be. Turnover by Moore. The Smith backhand. The rebound to Peluso. He's got an empty netter, and on the backhand, unbelievably, shoots it wide. Well, the Sharks and Jeff Hackett dodge a bullet.
Meanwhile, before and after that, a couple of nifty saves from Jeff Hackett. He's had a, I was going to say a whale of a game, but he's played very well in the Shark goal. Now it's in the San Jose zone again. And then cleared back to center ice. If Mullen touches it, he'll be offside, and the whistle sounds.
Hawks need to keep their composure. A lot of time remaining. We said the Sharks' third game in four nights, and they'll have many opportunities, the Blackhawks, to get back in this. They can't get them all back at once. They can't get caught four guys in deep. Just send the regular two guys in with the one guy in the deep slot. They'll get their chances.
By the way, I'd like to take back something I said very quickly right at the tail end of that second period when David Williams scored his goal to put San Jose in front. I said that the replay official here, the video replay official, should be calling down to Paul Stewart to let him know that the man was in the goal crease. I stand corrected. That is not a situation in which the goal judge can be involved. That's not one of those reviewable instances. So I stand corrected and am happy to admit it, and the video judge did right by doing nothing. That's Paul Stewart's call all the way. If he saw that the man's foot was in the crease, which it was, he would have ruled no goal. But that's not a call for the video replay man to make. Here's Presley with a two-on-one sandwich on Lemieux, but Lemieux still has the puck. Gosselin drops it back top of the ring. Chelios moves in, center one. Roll right through the crease by Gilbert. Now bodies flying all over the place. A big hitting shift from both teams. Here's a pass for Lemieux. It didn't connect and winds up back in the Chicago end. Teams really throwing their weight around. This is a good hockey game, a very spirited and well-contested contest. And now a good save by Hackett, kicks it away and out to center. Herkes a long drive, Belfour a blocker save there. And into the corner goes Smith. Puts it around the boards. Rob Brown on the near side. Gave it to Brent Sutter. He feeds Chelios. Now Smith works his way over the San Jose line, gets knocked down along the boards. Wilson shot it the other way. It's going to be an icing call against San Jose. 4.5 gone in the third period. San Jose 4, Chicago 2.
I try to ignore my sensitive teeth, but hot and cold foods hurt.
Don't ignore your sensitive teeth. They can be more serious than you think. Pain from one sensitive tooth can start the domino effect, make you stop brushing, lead to gingivitis, periodontal disease, even tooth loss. Dentists recommend Sensodyne most for sensitive teeth.
My dentist was right. Now my teeth don't feel sensitive.
Don't ignore sensitive teeth. Sensodyne helps stop the pain and the domino effect.
Banging and crashing. Good work by Lemieux. He gets away from Gates. Fends off Moore. Gets sandwiched by Presley, but knocks Presley away. Continues on. Very physical game. It's gotten more physical as each shift. has gone on, and the Blackhawks trying to force the issue here, trying to get back in. Trailing 4-2. Late goal of the second period, an early goal in the third period to give the Sharks the two-goal bulge.
Face-off to the left of Jeff Hackett. Sutter and Herkes get ready, or Graham and Herkes rather. Now Graham got the draw to Marchman across to Smith, top of the ring, shooting. Deflected wide by sliding Bruce. Into the corner goes Sutter. Brent Sutter against Herkes along the board. Now Graham came up with it, and then he's hounded. It's taken away by Bruce. And David Bruce got to center before Brown knocked him down. Still the Sharks able to dump it in. Ryan Marchman. In his own end to Smith. He flipped it to center. Sharks dump it back in there. Marchman. Took a hit from Anderson, but the Hawks come away with it. And nice feed to Roenick from Brown. Roenick over the line, leaving for Larmer, a drive. Right on! And a save by Hackett. And Jeff Hackett coming up with a great performance so far for San Jose.
Good passing by the Blackhawks, starting inside their own line. Brown took the hit, got it to Roenick, flying up the middle of the ice, draws the defenseman with him, drops it perfectly to Larmer. Larmer just shot it right into the midsection. Hackett, one of the few times where he's gone down early, shot hit him right in the chest, and he left no rebound.
The NHL pros set all. Face off to the right of the Shark goal. We mentioned most whatever success the Sharks have had, a great majority of it has come here on home ice. They're only four under 500 in their own rink. 10 wins, 14 losses, and two ties coming into tonight's action. Now the draw shot to center ice. Kuchera out it to Goulet, dumping it in there. Rob Zettler back. Perry Anderson can't locate it. He ran into Goulet in the corner, now wants a whistle, and he falls down on top of the puck to make sure he gets one. The broadcast rights to this game have been granted to Sports Channel and WBBM Radio solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any reproduction or other use of this game without the consent of Sports Channel and BBM Radio in Chicago is prohibited. Still 14 and a half minutes left in the third period, 4-2. In favor of the Sharks, face off to the left to Hackett. And the draw to Lemieux in behind the goal, trying to center. Peluso a shot. Shot it wide. Rebound taken by Lemieux. Lemieux digs it off the board, shooting. Hackett a stand up tape. Now Hudson. Big save by Hackett. Now Chelios. And Hackett stopped him. Jeff Hackett turning in a wonderful performance. In the Shark goal. Jeff Hackett still down to catch his breath, and he ought to be. He's been great. The Sharks lead 4-2.
Only $29.95. Become an Insiders member now.
Who joins these NFL fan clubs anyway?
I did, and I got a lifetime membership in my team's fan club, plus discounts on special merchandise for only $29.95.
$29.95?
Yeah, plus this exclusive membership kit with offers worth over $150.
How do I join?
Send $29.95, your name, address, and favorite team to Insiders, P.O. Box 9101, Oak Brook, Illinois, 60522, or call 900-535-9000 for details. Become an Insider of your favorite team now.
Well, Stewart helping Hackett have equipment repair. The banging and crashing results in a good opportunity. Jocelyn Lemieux's wrist shot. The rebound deflected. Hacked at by Hudson. Good save by the pad. Hudson misplays the rebound. Out front to Chelios. Chelios turns and whips a backhander right into Hackett, who's sitting down in the crease. 34 shots for the Blackhawks. Eight of them here in the third. Just over 5 minutes gone by.
What an acquisition for the Sharks to get Jeff Hackett in the expansion draft from the New York Islanders. And he's the veteran who's been weathering the storm behind this expansion team. They've got a kid in the minor leagues that may eventually be their goaltender of the future. Artur Irbe, the Soviet, who has had some very good outings here in the early part of the season with San Jose. They didn't want to throw him to the Wolves too early in his career, getting a chance to get acclimated in North America in the minor league. Hackett really terrific so far tonight. 4-2 San Jose. Falloon dumping it into the Chicago zone. Coming to the near side, held in by McGill, a long shot, fluttering. Belfour was careful with that knuckler, and he managed to get in the way. And now it's cleared to the Shark line. McGill couldn't get it out, now has it again. McGill in traffic, running into a little trouble, now knocked down on top of the puck. He got a stick from Rob Brown. Now Williams comes over to have, or Sullivan to have a word with Brown. The puck was underneath a sitting Bob McGill, and Brown tried to dig it loose. I think they both may be sent off here.
First penalties of the third period. It's been a very physical period. Started to get physical in the second, and it's really gotten better with every shift as far as that aspect of the game is concerned. McGill sat on top of the puck. Brown tried to play it, pry it loose. Then Sullivan and Brown had words, and they'll both be sent off at 6:51.
Last night, we mentioned the Sharks last in the league in offense. Last night is the first time they've won a game when they've given up more than 3 goals against. And they won that shootout last night. And there's Steve Smith with a drive and a save by Hackett. And the Hawks won the draw. Now Peluso out of the near corner. He ran into Gates. And then Lemieux in there trying to dig it loose. But his pass deflects, and Presley flipped it back into the Chicago zone. Mike Peluso got a rough ride from Moore, failed to clear it. And now Smith hoisting it over everybody's head back into Shark territory. And Steve Bozek puts it back into the Blackhawk end. And a bouncing puck at center ice. Finally dumped back into the... Now here's Gates and Peluso dropping the glove. Link Gates and Mike Peluso squaring off. They're all alone in the San Jose zone. Measuring one another. Nothing happening yet. And they're going to get delay of game penalties, I think. Now they do come together. Peluso a couple early left. Gates in the low. There's standing toe-to-toe and slugging it out with the left hand. And now wrapping one another up. And now Peluso switches to the right. Now back to the left. And two of the heavyweights in the NHL going at it here. And now Gates got in an uppercut. And he falls on top of Peluso. And the Shark fans love it. Just over 12 minutes to the third, 4-2 San.
Hi, I'm Ann Liguori, host of Sports Interview, the show that brings you in the living rooms of some of your favorite sports personalities. We're controversial at times.
I picked him as the number one center of all time. He was a complete basketball player.
Personal at times.
But you want that because you can't. We're talking about TV. We're talking about
making
money.
See, this is why we have a great marriage. We never agree on anything, but we know that from the start.
But we always learn a lot and have a great time doing it. So join me each week on Sports Interview.
Now two heavyweights going at it. Second altercation for Peluso in this game. He went at McGill, and now he goes with Gates, and Gates at the end gets one in. An uppercut, and then as he's down, Gates falls on top of him, jumped on top of him. But a good altercation, a good fight between two tough guys, and they went toe-to-toe. Second altercation, as we said, for Peluso in this one. He's done well in both of them. Offsetting fighting majors. Penalties coming at 7:45.
Yeah. Face off outside the Hawk line. It's controlled by Steve Smith. Flipped it ahead. And now here's Lemieux with a shot blocked by Zettler. Lemieux got it back over to the far side. Put it to the line. Marchman a long shot. Deflected inches wide. Zettler then lost it to Lemieux. His shot. Hackett the same rebound. Graham! How did he not get that pass, Hackett? Jeff Hackett brilliant again in the Shark goal. Now Marchman at center. His pass picked off. There's David Bruce, a long shot. Belfort steers it aside. And now Hercus to the corner, comes up with it, works in behind the wraparound, and didn't complete the move. Hercus in the near corner with it. Put it in behind, taken there by the Hawks. And Smith flipping it ahead to Michel Goulet. Gets into the Shark zone. Goulet's pass deflected, then Roenick carried on. Turns behind the net. Wilson tried to get to him. Roenick got away. Centered one. Big scramble in front of the goal. Where's the puck? Mullen has it. And Ryan Mullen airs it back into Chicago ice. And it will be an icing call against San Jose.
Well, Hackett, I don't know much more he can do. This is unbelievable goaltending by Hackett. Hawks have been storming the San Jose zone this entire third period, but the only goal has gone to the Sharks 35 seconds into the period. Jocelyn Lemieux having a great game and a great third period. Wrist shot right on, kicked at, almost swatted in by the defenseman, but Graham just had it hop over his stick with an empty net chance. Second empty net chance of the period, one for Peluso and that one for Dirk Graham. Just a matter of time before the Hawks strike score against Hackett. They just have to be careful they don't give up an odd man break, getting so much pressure and so many opportunities. They have a tendency to get four and five guys in too deep.
Now everybody ready. Here's the draw taken by the Sharks. Wayne Pressly clearing it. To the Chicago line. Chelios on it to Larmer. Steve Larmer trying to send it out. Then he got it back, but Goulet is ruled offside on the play.
Backhand pass attempt was slowed somewhat. Came back to Larmer. Goulet couldn't hold up.
Next special event. Here comes the Sharks official mascot. You can have the Shark appear at your next corporate gathering, promotion.
Well, at long last, this road trip will come to an end on Saturday night in the arena in St. Louis. To combine all the difficulties of being away from home for so long, the final game of the trip, a divisional game on the road. And so we'll be in St. Louis Arena, 7:20 radio pregame show, 7:30 on television, the Hawks and the Blues, Saturday night from St. Louis. Here's Williams into the Hawks onto his backhand, shooting, and a save by Belfort. Rebound, they score! On the rebound, Pat Falloon makes it 5-2 San Jose.
Well, Williams, a defenseman, comes in from his right point, all alone, no one near him. He comes in on the backhand, walks in, goes to the backhand. Belfort kicked it away. Falloon gets the rebound. Belfort's down and out, but Williams, all kinds of time and room, no one even near him. And Belfort makes the save. Everybody collapsing, but Falloon was able to get to it and tuck it in, and it's a 5-2 Shark lead. Blackhawks have dominated the period. Most of the play has been in the Shark zone, but two goals for San Jose here in the third. Falloon getting the rebound. And the Sharks making the best of their chances here in the second or third period.
15 goals for Pat Falloon. That leads the San Jose team now. And a 5-2 Shark lead. And now the puck is over the glass and into the crowd. We're halfway through the third period, and the Hawks in a heap of trouble, trailing the Sharks 5-2.
The NHL, from modest beginnings, stemmed the pride of Montreal. From hockey's Man of Steel to a rocket named Rashine, Espo, Bobby, and the heroics of Bossy. Shutting the door, plus a streaking LeFleur. From father to son, and the magic of the Great One. A propelling goal to Lord Stanley's Cup held high. Celebrate the National Hockey League's 75th anniversary on Sports Channel America.
That Falloon, rather composed young man on the bench with a big smile on his face, gets his 15th of the year. Looks like he's enjoying himself.
So Pat Falloon from David Williams at 925. And the Sharks with two nights in a row in which they've scored five goals. That is a real achievement for this team that's had a tough time putting the puck in the net, a tougher time than anybody else in the league. This team is last in offense. They've scored five tonight. And the Hawks' Cam Russell trying to keep one in. The puck goes into the crowd, and now we have a little scuffle along the boards. Beginning to separate. So we'll have a face-off outside the Shark line. Sutter, Brown, and Lemieux are on for Chicago. The Dean Evason line for San Jose, with Perry Anderson and Jeff Odgers. Little ice repair needed in the neutral area. And now we're ready to go. As dropped the puck unfairly, so we weren't as ready as we thought. Dumps it into the Shark zone. Doug Wilson back. Wilson. Gonna feed Evason. Dean Evason slips it out to center. Sharks dump it in. Taken by Sutter. Swung it around the boards. Wilson held it in to Evason along the far side. Clipped it in behind the goal. Buskus, who hasn't played in an eternity, gets it out to center ice. And Lemieux stopped there by Wilson. Hawks nearly got caught. They had too many men on the ice. Fortunately, everybody was right in front of the Hawk bench. And so the play goes on. Here's Rob Brown trying to cut it. He's knocked down. And David Bruce comes up with it for San Jose and bangs it to center ice. Hawks dump it in. Settler got a rough ride from Roenick. Chelios played the puck. He dug it out, but his pass is picked off and cleared to center. Anisek Kuchera to Steve Larmer on the left side. Larmer unable to advance it. Here's Mullen racing into the Hawk zone. Belfour out of the net. Got him with a stick. Mullen down. Belfour's going to get a penalty. Brian Mullen chasing after that loose puck, and Belfour got the stick up.
He followed through. The puck's coming along the top of the circle. Belfour comes to play it and has followed through the shot. The shot hit him in the face. That's clearly accidental. He was shooting the puck and the follow through hit him in the face. And I imagine it's only going to be a 2-minute penalty.
Well, Paul Stewart, I think, is going to give more than that. He seems to be indicating a 4-minute penalty. Let's see what the call is on Ed Belfour.
If it's drawing blood, it's a 4-minute penalty if it's accidental. That's the penalty that's supposed to be called instead of that 5-minute major if they rule it an accidental situation.
Four minutes for high sticking.
It's a 4-minute penalty, a double minor for high sticking on Belfour. The Sharks with an opportunity to get even more breathing room. They already lead 5-2.
The number displaying now on your screen should be used to respond to the following.
This is an important message for U.S. veterans. Whether you serve during peacetime or war, call now for free information about veterans' term life insurance. That's just $1 a week. Benefits are guaranteed never to go down and are paid from day one. Only veterans, spouses, and widows ages 30 to 69 qualify for this $1 a week offer. Don't wait. Call now for free information from Veterans Life Insurance Company.
Belfort gets a four-minute high-sticking penalty at 11:15. Belfort with 22 minutes in penalties coming into tonight's action. And he came out to clear the puck, a bouncing puck along the dot. Mullen was breaking in on the net. He came out to shoot it, and the follow-through clipped him. And it's a four-minute high-sticking penalty.
So nearly half of the time remaining in this game, the Sharks should have a power play opportunity. There's a Graham steal. He got it to the top of the ring, and Kuchera put it back behind the net. Graham after it to the far side, and Hudson jammed it loose to Graham's side of the goal. Kuchera sneaks in. Graham centered it. It's picked off. Good work by Graham and Hudson forechecking. They've drawn a San Jose penalty, so that'll take care of at least half of this power play time.
Williams will go to the box. Williams having an eventful night, a goal and an assist. This time a penalty for holding. Good work by Hudson and Graham in the corner. Graham had it towards the left of the net. He tried the wraparound coming on the far side, and in his attempt, he was pulled down. Good call by Stewart, so that'll help the Blackhawk cause. Down by a field goal with 8:23 to go. The Sharks with two goals on five shots here in the third period. The three straight goals for them. Late in the second and early in the third, and then midway through the third. Goals by Williams, Fenton, and Falloon.
So four skaters aside here. As Sutter and Lemieux come on for Chicago against Hercus and Mullen for San Jose. Doug Wilson and Paul Stewart exchanging pleasantries there. Wilson with a little equipment repair. Paul Stewart helping him get dressed back up. And here's the draw, controlled by the Sharks. Mullen on the right side over the line. Stopped along the boards, rolled it in there deep, taken by Sutter. Now Chelios. Here's Chelios for Lemieux on the far board, trying to move in there on Wilson. Came loose, and Hercus feeds Mullen, who rolled it to center. Now Wilson, taking it into the hog zone. Jocelyn Lemieux, going to wind it up for Chicago. Lifted ahead, it's picked off by Jason Moore. Long feed to Balloon on right wing, trying to cut in there on Smith. Puck rolled free, otherwise he might have had half a step. Now the Hawks come up with it. And back to center, Buskus over the line to Graham. Graham with a wrist shot and a save by Hackett. Rebound Balloon. At Balloon, three on three to the Hawks line. Stops, dropped it to, no, he's going to hang on to it. And Moore was wide open. He was reluctant to pass it to him. And now off the play, Mike Hudson knocked the man down. And Brian Lawton hit the deck. Hudson's going to get a penalty. And the Hawks doing a lot to hurt themselves here in the late going.
Well, the problem with that penalty is when Lawton was knocked down, Hudson gave him a cross check in the back of the helmet while he was down. A bad penalty by Mike Hudson. And the Blackhawks are hurting themselves here. Falloon carries it in. Lawton was taken by Hudson. Hudson pulls him down. While Hudson was on top of him, he gave a cross check to the back of the helmet of Lawton, and that results in the penalty for roughing. It was right in front of Stewart. And Stewart had to make the call.
The Sharks have a 4-on-3 power play now. In 48 seconds, they're going to have a two-man advantage for over a minute. So the Blackhawks could not be in a much deeper hole than they are right now. A 5-2 San Jose lead, 7 minutes left in the third, and the Sharks on the power play for quite a period of time now. Here's the draw taken by Kuchera, clearing it out to center. Four against three for San Jose. David Bruce dumping it in. Chelios to the corner, had it knocked away. Hercus in behind the net, centered one more. Neal's off to the boards with it. Mason Moore on the near side to Herkes in the deep slot. Gave it back to Moore, tees it up. Then he wouldn't shoot it. Moore hangs on. Back to the line. Now here's Herkes, a drive, and he shot it up off the glass. Rebound, Moore centering, bouncing puck. Larmer stole it. Larmer got tied up along the far side, still kicking it. Back to the Shark line. Jason Moore. Now the Shark penalty is over, and a two-man advantage for just over a minute for San Jose. And here's a Graham steal, but he was in offside.
Graham, one of the premier penalty killers in the league, trying to get something going, trying to get a shorthanded goal. Tough to do now, though, two men down. In a minute and 5 seconds, there will be two men down. Was this the 35th time this year the Blackhawks will have been two men short? At least 35. 31 all season last year. They've done well in the situations, but they've gotten a lot of practice at it. And this will be the 36th time that they've been short two men. They've only allowed 8 goals against, which is an incredible statistic.
Here's Wilson losing it at center. Back comes Graham trying to cut in. Graham got wrapped up nicely. Nice play there by Williams to prevent a shot from Dirk Graham. Now the Sharks come out with it. Mullen flipped it over the line. Lawton to the far corner. Ryan Lawton dropped it back to Doug Wilson, across to Williams. Back to Wilson, deep slot. He centered one. And touch pass attempted and picked off by Sutter. And he cleared it. Brian Mullen trying to make a quick touch pass, and it didn't connect. David Williams feeding it back into the Hawk end. Kuchera tied up by Presley. Now the puck loose along the boards. Lemieux and Lawton crash on the far side. Sharks dig it out. Jason Moore near circle. Fires! Belfort with a save. Rebounded behind. And now the first Hawk penalty's over. A one-man power play for San Jose. As Hudson just out of the box got it to center, and Lemieux finished the job. Moore and Hudson back of the net. Hudson just slugged it right in the face. I think he's going to get away with it. I didn't see the arm of Stewart go up into the air. Moore and Hudson bumping heavily along the boards. It looked like Jason Moore was given a good glove from Hudson right in the yap. And looks like everybody will be able to cool off, and I don't think there's going to be a penalty here, or maybe I'm wrong. Stewart looks like he may be calling it. One or two. Five.
Get ready to launch yourself into the world of Air and Space Smithsonian, a world that captivates the imagination. Satellites, superjets, soaring, something different every other month. There's no other magazine like Air and Space, and with your subscription comes membership in the National Air and Space Museum in Washington.
To order Air and Space, call 800-841-0300 and receive a full year, 6 issues for just $18 with membership in the National Air and Space Museum. 800-841-0300.
There was a good reason that Mike Hudson was upset with Jason Moore.
Moore hit him twice in the head with an elbow while he had his back to him, and he got elbowed into the glass. Second time tonight where Hudson's been elbowed. Then he took a slug at him, and rightfully so. And Moore just whacked him twice, but that was a cheap shot initially by Moore. Hit from behind with the elbow, and that cut Hudson. That should be a 5-minute penalty. Hitting from behind, and that's it. Moore's gone. 5-minute penalty. With 4:53 to go, and that was the right call. Excellent call. Well, Moore with an early shower, and the Blackhawks with only 8 seconds left on the penalty. The 4-minute penalty to Belfort. We'll have a power play to end the game. Chicago. Oh, if they're going to come from behind, now's the time.
Hudson's also going to get a penalty here. So Hudson gets a roughing penalty, and Moore, and Jason Moore with a 5-minute butt ending penalty at 15:07. So the Hawks will eventually play. They're only going to have the last 3 minutes of the game with which to have the extra man.
last 5 minutes here to get the tie and force it to overtime. He had a lot of chances at Hackett early in the period, but that last goal by Falloon sort of put the silencer, and then the penalties, the 4 minute penalty and the penalty to Hudson, really taking the momentum and starts out of the Blackhawks attack.
Here's the draw now. The Sharks with an extra man brings a few more seconds. Chelios deep in his own end. And now we have four skaters aside for the next couple of minutes. Jeremy Roenick flips it ahead, broken up by Williams. Hawks hold it in, then a stolen away by Falloon. At Falloon, posted to the neutral area. Now Falloon nearly stole it from Chelios. To move in, he tied up, and now he gets it into the San Jose zone. Gave it to Graham on the near side. He stood up there by Zettler. It's cleared back the other way. And Belfour is out of the net to play. Gave it to Smith. Steve Smith giving it in. Peluso to the far side. Mike Peluso lost the handle. Doug Wilson clears it back to center ice. Dirk Graham had his pass stolen by Mullen. He flipped it toward Belfour, who was careful with it. And now Graham starts back. Hawks dump it in. Half a minute left on the Chicago penalty, then Chicago will finish the game on the power play. And here's a two-line pass by San Jose.
San Francisco Union Park on the Nolan Special Shuttle will be provided from the Balboa Park dark spaces for all Shark games. The
Justin Lemieux has really played hard all night long. He's been banging and crashing, creating a lot of those chances in the early going of this period because of his muscle and hard work. But Hackett shut the door here in this third period, especially in the first half. And Sharks scored early on their first chance and then scored on their next chance. Two goals in the first five shots after the Blackhawks peppered the San Jose net. Hackett stood tall and Sharks were able to counter and score two in this period. They have the 5-2 lead. Three unanswered goals by San Jose.
And it's dumped into the Hog zone. Cam Russell is back for it. Gave it to Goulet to center. Michel Goulet gets the line, and offside is the call.
Goulet needing one more for 500, and he'll be glad to get that. See him much more relaxed, Goulet, I would think, once he scores his next goal. 3 seconds, the Blackhawks will go to the power play. Need to score quickly and often with this power play. They are 1-for-5 on the power play prior to this one. It's like a promising situation after Roenick tied it up at 18:56 in the power play. It looked like the Blackhawks were going to be well on their way for a big win, but a late goal right after that, 24 seconds or 23 seconds after the fact. Williams made it 3-2, and Sharks have not looked back. Good goaltending by Hackett.
Good goaltending bordering on the spectacular. On several occasions tonight, Jeff Hackett has been terrific. The Hawk penalty now over both teams, or I should say Chicago, finishing this game on the power play. And it's a 5-2 Shark lead as it's dumped into the San Jose zone. On the near side, Smith a long shot, sailing wide. Presley the rebound, flipped it ahead to Bozek. He clears. Steal by Presley, wasting a little more time. Got it into the corner. Jeremy Roenick takes over. Then a bad pass stolen by Wilson, who shot the flex over the glass and into the crowd.
A
Wilson has not scored tonight. 9 points in his last 8 games with 5 goals and 4 assists, but he had a lot of chances in the first 2 periods. 3 real super chances from the deep slot, but Belfour stoned him every time.
Minutes to go. San Jose on the brink of their 13th victory of the year and their 11th at home. Here's the draw. Cam Russell flipping it ahead. Broken up. Russell got it back. Russell flipped it behind the goal. Goulet chipped it along the boards. Hudson wrestling for it. Got help from Larmer. Steve Larmer on the near side. Put it back to the line. Kuchera. Slipped it across to Russell. His long shot is blocked by Everson. The race is on. Everson going to have a breakaway. Russell yanked him down. And a penalty will be called on Cam Russell. I thought for a minute it might be a penalty shot, but no. It'll be a minor penalty called on Russell.
I think it should be a penalty shot. Everson blocks the shot. Russell tries to swat at it. Takes away. Everson would have pulled away. He's pulling away. He's pulling away. Cam Russell just dives totally headlong and pulls him down, not allowing Everson a shot on goal or a chance. It should have been a penalty shot. Well, that's it with the power play action for the Blackhawks. Minute 28 remaining. The Sharks, a minute 35 still remaining on their 5-minute major to Moore. Sharks with a 5-2 lead. They have scored 2 goals here in this period, and on their first, they scored 1 goal in their first shot, and then 2 in their 5, and they've had 6 the entire period. Blackhawks had 11 shots, but they all came in the first half of the period.
Lemieux with a wrist shot, well wide, and back at center is Chelios. It ahead. Lemieux's pass is deflected. We're into the final minute of the game. Here's Chelios moving in with a long shot that is deflected wide. And Lemieux put it in behind. Wilson able to pick it up there for San Jose, clearing it back to the Chicago end of the ice. And the Hawks make a two-line pass with half a minute left. Well, Jeff Hackett faced 37 shots so far in the game, and of the 35 saves he has made, he might be close to double digits in spectacular saves.
We saw him last year do the same type of thing with the Islanders against the Blackhawks, but he played confidently, stood up, did not go down, played the angles. When he did go down, he still made the save on the second and third attempts.
The first 3 games of their road trip, the Blackhawks scored 10 goals. They won all 3 games. In the last 3 games of their road trip, the Hawks will have scored 3 goals and lost all 3 of those games. And the remaining fans here in the Cow Palace begin to rise to salute their Sharks as Smith shoots one wide. Here's Kuchera holding it in. 10 seconds left. And there's on their feet in the Cow Palace, and San Jose has a 2-game winning streak. Jeff Hackett waiting for the parade to get to him, and a happy bunch of San Jose Sharks congratulating Jeff Hackett, who really turned in a terrific performance tonight. And the Blackhawk road trip, which started in a way that might suggest it might be a world-beating road trip, now all of a sudden there's 1 game left to try to remain above 500. The Hawks won their first 3. They've lost their next 3 while scoring 3 goals total in 3 games. 2 unanswered goals for San Jose in the third period to send the Sharks to the victory. Paul Fenton with his 2nd of the game from Bozek and Presley at the 35-second mark. And then Pat Falloon from David Williams at 9:25 who finish it off for San Jose. The Hawks outshot the Sharks 11-6 in the third and 37-28 in the game. But San Jose is now just three games under 500 at home. Their 13th win of the year overall, 5-2. The Sharks win it.
Baseball has been around for over 150 years. That's why the Postal Service honored America's game with its very own stamp in 1939. And now you can honor past and present players with the official Major League Baseball postage stamp. These are genuine stamps featuring 80 of the greats in the game. Andre Dawson, Daryl Strawberry, Wade Boggs, along with 300-game winner Nolan Ryan. Catch all your favorite stars in this stunning baseball collector's edition containing 80 official stamps. You also get this deluxe 64-page hardcover album that details the history of baseball. Regular price is normally $29.95, but this special offer is only $19.95 for the premier issue of Major League Baseball in stamps.
With your credit card order of the baseball stamps for $19.95, you will be able to receive a set of three commemorative Desert Storm envelopes for an additional $10.50. For every Desert Storm order, $1 will be donated to the Red Cross. Call today, 1-800-762-1150. That's 1-800-762-1150.
If you could be the executive producer, would you choose this event or this event? With the Olympics Triple Cast, you'll get 24-hour coverage for 15 days on three cable channels. So now, for the 92 Barcelona Olympics, you can choose your event. Call today. The Olympics Triple Cast, a whole new way to see the games.
Make this the winter you learn to ski better with tips and techniques from ski's top teaching pros. Found in this all-new Ski Better Now video, yours free. Call this toll-free number today, and Ski Magazine will send you this video free with your paid subscription of only $11.94. Enjoy a full season of Ski Magazine, America's top-rated magazine for skiers. Beginner or expert, reach new levels of ability. Call today to get Ski Magazine, plus your free video, and Ski Better Now.
San Jose with a 5-2 victory over the Chicago Blackhawks tonight. And the Hawk road trip now has a record of 3-3. And as we mentioned, just three goals for the Blackhawks in the last three games of this trip. And you're not going to have a very easy time winning at home with those kind of numbers. You certainly are not going to win on the road with that sort of offensive output. And now the road trip is a 500 level and one more chance to move over 500 on Saturday night in St. Louis. But the Blackhawks look like they're in pretty good shape. They get a power play goal to tie the game late in the second. They give up the lead just a few seconds later, and then in the first minute of the third period, maybe the back-breaking goal.
Well, you don't ever want to give up a goal in the last minute of a period or the first minute of a period. Early in the period, after the Hawks were putting pressure, good counter, nice touch pass from Presley to Bozak. Bozak gets around Brown, gets the backhander. Belfour with his stick on the ice, he's down. The rebound right out to Chelios. Chelios should have had him tied up better than that. And Fenton put it in the net, and that made it a 4-2 San Jose lead. The Blackhawks came on from there, put a lot of pressure on the Sharks, but Jeff Hackett was brilliant in the nets.